Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to TAW Aftershock. My name is Josh Agedin, and I am so excited to finally bring you guys our ninth TAW pay-per-view event, just main roster, of course, and we have a tremendous show for you here tonight. We're kicking it off with a number one contenders match inside a steel cage. It's Broly, the new Broly, versus Bane in an Escape the Cage steel cage match. No pinfalls, no submission. The only way to win is by escaping the cage. And here comes Broly, fresh off of his victory over Gohan in that Dragon Ball Super Broly promo match. I hope you guys had a wonderful Christmas and preparing to have a good new year. What a way to close out 2018 and with TAW Aftershock. So much is going to be happening tonight. We have this cage match. We have a Fatal 4-Way Excalibur Championship match. We have Triple Threat Women's Championship match. We have a Fatal Championship match. We have a First Blood match. We have a Last Chance Championship match, and we have Jason versus Sephiroth, and of course our main event, 7-on-7 Tag Team Elimination match for the future of the Clown World Order and for the TAW Championship. What a night this is going to be, and of course kicking off the show with Broly versus Bane, Round 3, because these two, they're pretty much tied. At No Escape, Broly defeated Bane via no contest, but via referee stoppage, excuse me. And at Riot Central 2, when they had an Extreme Rules match, Bane won in what was an absolutely brutal match. They pulverized each other for like almost 20 to 30 minutes. It was ridiculous. And they went through almost all of the barricades. I'm kind of amazed that none of our fans were injured, so that was a brutal match. But again, this is the rubber match between these two, and the winner will face whoever the Molecular Champion is at Perfect Storm 2, one of our upcoming pay-per-view events after Aftershock. That's very redundant. After Aftershock. Thank you, Josh, again. But yeah, winner is the number one contender for the Molecular Championship. They'll either be going up against Dracula or Deadpool, whoever wins that championship match later tonight. And again, these two have been going at it for a while. It all started way back at TAW Crash Course, during the Crash Course match, because during that match, Bane actually eliminated Broly, which pissed Broly off, so Broly turned around and speared him, allowing the Joker to pin Bane and eliminate him. So then they had Bane tried to get revenge on Broly at No Escape. That did not work out, but he did get a little bit of revenge at Riot Central 2 in their humongous Extreme Rules match. But again, they're pretty much tied one-on-one, and this is the rubber match. Steel cage, only way to win is to escape, and here we go. And immediately starting with a flying knee right to the jaw. Yeah, Broly not very happy, because remember a few weeks ago, Bane powerbombed Broly. Well, now Broly powerbombed Bane on top of a car. And look at this. Just launching him face first into the steel cage. For the first time in this match, the cage has been used as a weapon. And there's the second time. Yeah, Bane has not forgotten about that powerbomb. And, oh, diving axe handle. That was almost a diving headbutt. And now just, all got caught. Oh, with a big spine buster by Broly. Got caught with that humongous spine buster. And it's almost like Broly's just a little bit taller now. It's the new Dragon Ball Super version of Broly, but still hates Bane nonetheless. Oh, look at this off that huge combo. Oh, look at the strength of Broly right into a power slam. But again, no pinfalls or submissions in this match. The only way to win is to escape the cage over the top or through the door. And they're both right next to the door. And just launching Broly right into the corner. Oh, but a counter and an elbow right to the face, right to the mask of Bane. And now Broly, oh, DDT, oh, counter. And now Bane into a DDT of his own. Beautiful counter by Bane. And some more punches. And a very surprising factor in this matchup, neither of these two men have ever won a championship in TAW. Oh, look at this. Oh, big headbutt right into the face. And what a belly-to-belly suplex by Bane, launching him all the way across the ring. Bane is no slouch. He might be lacking in size, but he's still a strong dude. Don't count him out. But a counter by Broly. And now he's got him up against the cage, and just a knee right in the face. But again, neither of these guys have won a championship in TAW thus far. But this match, again, is a number one contenders match, so it could go a long way in deciding whether or not these two will win the Molecular Championship. One nice counter by Broly, dodging the punch and just sending him flying with that takedown. But if you're Deadpool or Dracula, I would you don't want either of these men to win this match, to be perfectly honest, because you're going to have to put your title up against either Bane or Broly. Well, I counter into a big belly-to-belly suplex. Nice move by Bane. And again, these two have had wars against each other. Oh, counter. Oh, into the cage, and another spinebuster. It was almost a flapjack into the cage, but Broly also turning it into a spinebuster. But Bane right back up, runs right into a big punch right into the face. Oh, go behind by Broly, deceptively quick, and a shot right to the back, and they're very arrogant. Oh, but get caught in another spinebuster. That's three spinebusters in this match so far. And shocker, Bane's back has got to be hurting. And now counter, all but runs right to him with the shoulder block, did not knock him down, but a side headlock. Oh, look at that! Look at the speed of Broly with that takedown! Beautiful move by Broly. And now Broly perhaps going to try to escape the cage. No, Bane back up to his feet. Going to have to do a lot more than that. Now a collar and elbow tie-up as these two struggle to gain control. And an old right elbow right to the back of Broly's head. You'd think that giant hair would protect him, but whatever. Oh, look at this! Oh, the agility of Bane! Into a big Frankensteiner, and look at this, Bane trying to escape the cage, the first escape attempt of the night. Oh, look at this. Oh, but Broly immediately rips Bane off the cage. Nice move by Broly, very smart. I still can't believe Bane pulled off that Hurricane Rana. That was very impressive. Now some big punches to the face, and Broly picking Bane right back up. And again, this is a steel cage match, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, got knocked right into the cage. Oh, look at this. Oh, just slamming Bane face first into the cage over and over. Oh, but Bane stopped him. Oh, a shot right to the chest. And, oh, a wicked headbutt by Bane. He just knocked Broly right off his feet. Oh, launching him face first into the steel cage once again. And Bane is in command. Broly is in a world of trouble right now. You'd think that that win over Gohan that Broly had would give him a little bit of momentum, but so far not. Oh, but a counter. As soon as I speak, nice takedown by Broly off the counter of the front chancery. And now picking back up. And now a front chancery by Broly. Oh, a big clothesline. And now just a front mount and just big left hands right to the side of the face of Bane. Right to the temple, it looked like. Going back in for more. Some more left hands right to the temple. Trying to bust Bane open. And now, oh, a big shot right in the midsection. But Bane firing back with a nice chop right to the chest. Broly has a lot of chest, so that probably didn't do all that much. And now throwing him into the corner. And now, oh, shoulder blocks right to the midsection. Smart move by Bane, trying to immobilize him. Oh, and a knee right to the face in the corner. And, oh, a shot right to the back with that huge elbow drop. Take away Bane's, take away Broly's back. You take away a lot of his power. But again, he's got a big back. Everything on Broly is really big. That's a nice drop right there. But yeah, I mean, seriously, Broly is a huge dude. It's going to take a lot to put him down. But Bane has defeated Broly in the past, so it's not impossible. And now trying to choke him out with his knee in the corner. A little bit of payback for that knee in the corner earlier by Broly. And, oh, but blocking that punch. And, oh, another block. And now with this guy, I'm in an arm wringer. And, oh, a shot right to the elbow. Oh, but, oh, got caught. And another spinebuster. Broly really loves those spinebusters, ladies and gentlemen. And that's, it's ironic, doing it to Bane, the man who broke the bat. So, again, that's very ironic. And now going after the legs of Bane. Because, again, if Bane gets his legs taken out, he can't do much of his offense, which relies on power, pretty much. And some more chops. Shot to the midsection. And, oh, went for a shoulder block, but did not connect. Oh, but got caught, and another spinebuster by Broly. Good lord, how many times can you give a dude a spinebuster before his spine actually busts? And a big axe handle. And, oh, what a spear by Broly. Just about speared him through the cage. And now, oh, look at this. Broly's making a break for it. He's trying to bail. This may be his best opportunity. Bane is down off that humongous spear. Oh, Bane back up, but Broly's over the top. Oh, this could be it for Bane. Bane going as fast as he can, trying to scale the cage. Broly's at the top. Oh, no, this is going to end badly. And, oh, what a fall right into the middle of the ring. That had to hurt both competitors. But I think Broly's a little worse for wear because he's bigger and he fell farther. Oh, but look at Bane. Man, that was a hard fall. Man, Broly's out of it. Look at this. Catapult. Oh, right face first into the cage. Man, and look at this. Bane with an Irish whip. What's he setting up for? And, oh, pop up. Look at the strength of... Oh, my God. Look at the strength of Bane. Pop up. Going for the Rise of the Darkness. Look at the strength of this man. And the Rise of the Darkness connects. That's how he defeated Broly at Riot Central 2. But this time he did a pop up into it. I've never seen that before. Very impressive, and that all this might be Bane's biggest opportunity. He's trying to scale the cage, but Broly is back up almost immediately. What is it going to take to stop this guy? and again gets ripped off the cage. Look at this shot of the midsection, and another one. Oh, look at this. Broly's pissed. Broly's setting up for the Omega Eraser, a huge Omega Eraser. Not one of his biggest, but I think he's a little bit weakened in this matchup. And all this might be another opportunity to escape the cage. Can Broly win this matchup here? This is Broly's opportunity. Bane is down, but he's back up to his feet as soon as I say something. Oh, look at this. Bane's almost there. Oh, but Bane, oh, rips Broly off the cage. Broly was close right there. Both these guys hitting each other with their finishing maneuvers, but still not enough. Oh, but a counter. Throwing Bane, oh, right into the corner. Now look at this, Bane. Oh, Bane's in trouble. Broly setting up perhaps for a superplex. Oh boy, don't break the ring, please. And oh, what a massive superplex. I'm honestly surprised they didn't break the ring. Can you imagine if they broke the ring in the first match of the night? Oh, but that cage door just swung wide open from the impact, and now it's a race for the door. Can Broly escape the cage? The door's open. Can Bane stop him? Bane's trying to get his foot. Oh, but Broly's right there. Broly might be able to win this. He's trying to escape through the door. If he escapes through the door, Broly is the number one contender. Oh, he's almost there. This is a race, ladies and gentlemen. Who's going to get it? And Broly almost there. He's right there at the door. Can he escape the cage? Bane trying to stop him. Oh, and Broly. Broly, he's out. He's out. Broly has won the match and is the number one contender for the TAW Molecular Championship. Oh, that has got to be heartbreak for Bane right there. Was not fast enough, and that superplex took its toll, but Broly has won the rubber match, has defeated Bane inside the steel cage via escaping through the door. I don't think we've seen someone escape through the door in TAW yet, but Broly will challenge the winner of the Deadpool versus Dracula match for the Molecular Championship at Perfect Storm 2. What a huge win by Broly. Finally getting a championship match. What a way to kick off the show with an intense steel cage match. And that fall earlier in the match, that was devastating. Probably hurt both guys. But a huge win for Broly. But speaking of championships, up next, ladies and gentlemen, our first championship match of the night. The Excalibur Championship is on the line in a Fatal 4-Way Elimination Match. We've got L versus Chris Jericho versus Venom versus Jeff Hardy. Fatal 4-Way Elimination Match. There are no disqualifications or countouts. Only way to win or only way to eliminate your opponents is by pinfall or submission. And again, we have Chris Jericho, Jeff Hardy, Venom, and L in this matchup. And remember, ladies and gentlemen, the Excalibur Championship is pretty much Money in the Bank. It's like if Money in the Bank was a championship that you have to regularly defend. It's a title you have to defend as you hold it, but you can turn it in whenever you want to for a TAW Championship opportunity. So it's pretty much like, again, the Money in the Bank Championship. And here comes our first competitor in this matchup, Chris Jericho, who, honestly, he had a bunch of momentum, especially coming out of Riot Central 2 when he defeated Jeff Hardy in that great matchup at Riot Central 2. And then he defeated Jeff Hardy in a steel cage match. But after that, he was defeated by Venom and L, so that derailed a lot of Chris Jericho's momentum. So he might pull out the win in this matchup, might win the Excalibur Championship, I have no idea. But his momentum has been tainted as of late. But Chris Jericho is still a wily veteran, and he has an alliance with Jacob Cass, so who knows what's going to happen. And again, he's involved in both TAW and XAW, so a lot on Chris Jericho's mind right now, especially considering that he's lost a little bit of that momentum he had. If he had kept that momentum going, then he'd be my favorite to win this thing. But honestly, my favorite to win this thing is L, because L has pinned every single competitor in this matchup. He's pinned Chris Jericho, he's pinned Jeff Hardy, and he's pinned the man coming out right now, Venom, who's coming out to his new theme songs by Eminem. I'm not a big fan of rap, but it's a pretty funny song. The music video for that Venom song is absolutely hysterical. Just people freaking out with the Eminem face. It's hysterical. If you haven't seen the Venom music video, go watch it. It's totally worth that 5 minutes. But here comes Venom, who actually defeated Chris Jericho in a singles match. And his new movie just came out on DVD, and I bought it for Christmas. I think it's an alright movie. It's very enjoyable, very entertaining. Especially the weird part with Venom. If you haven't seen the Venom movie, I do recommend it. It's not the best movie, but it's a lot of fun. And here comes the man that I believe, honestly, anyone could take this matchup, but if a gun to my head, I'm going with L. Because, again, he has so much momentum. He won that Battle Royal. It was his second match in TAW. His first match was a Royal Rumble. But he won that battle royal, then he pinned Chris Jericho, then he pinned Venom, and then he pinned Jeff Hardy. He has defeated every single competitor in this Fatal 4-Way matchup. So he has the biggest wave of momentum going into this matchup. But again, it's Fatal 4-Way rules, elimination, and there are no disqualifications or counters. You can use weapons. You could have a buddy interfere if you wanted to. I don't know if L has any friends in the locker room. Maybe Ryuk. I mean, they're from the same series, but I've never seen them team up, so I don't know. Maybe it's a possibility, but I do believe that Ryuk might be watching this match in the back. I mean, they are. They do know each other, so I have no idea. But again, this is a very easy match to lose, but a very hard match to win. And here comes our final competitor, Jeff Hardy, and in this match, continuing his rivalry with Chris Jericho that dates back to before Riot Central 2. They had a matchup at Riot Central 2, and Chris Jericho was victorious with a huge springboard top rope codebreaker. I know it sounds ridiculous, but when you go back and watch that match, it makes sense somehow. It's awesome to watch, but very devastating for Jeff Hardy's face. And then he got defeated by Chris Jericho again in a steel cage match on the XAW preview show. But however, he won that triple threat match against Jason Voorhees and Sephiroth to earn his way into this championship opportunity. So here we go, Fatal 4-Way for the Excalibur Championship, and I've already explained the importance of this belt. You have the belt, you can turn it in for the TAW Championship as long as you have it. But if you defend it regularly and you lose it, then it's like a championship. You lose the championship to someone else, and then they can turn it in whenever they want to. So here we go, the Excalibur Championship is on the line, our first title match of the night, and what a shock, Jeff Hardy going right after Chris Jericho, but gets caught, and oh, suplex right on the top of his head by Venom. What a vicious Tazplex that looked like. What a vicious suplex right on the top of his head. And now Jeff Hardy going after L. Man, that had to ring his bell. And now look at this, Jericho throwing Venom to the outside. Look at this, Jericho with a springboard dropkick knocking Venom out of the ring, and Jeff Hardy with a diving leg drop. Yeah, this is going to be kind of hard to call until people start getting eliminated because there's four bodies flying all over the place. And only is throwing L to the outside, and Jeff, oh, spearing him right into the announce table. And now Chris Jericho suplexing Venom back into the ring. Nice suplex showing off some strength. And now Jeff Hardy going after Chris Jericho. What's Jeff going to do here? Oh, just going for a whisper in the wind early in this matchup. Got him right in the face. Oh, but that may have just pissed Chris Jericho off. Oh, runs into another boot in the face with a dropkick. And now Jeff Hardy and L going after Venom, going after the bigger man. Now Venom undoubtedly has the strength advantage in this matchup. And I believe Jericho has the strategy advantage. Jeff Hardy and L are pretty much the wild cards in this match. But a nice hip toss by L. And into the cover, one, but only a one count. First pinfall attempt of the night. And only got a one count. With some, oh, look at that nice combo by L. Man, he rung Venom's bell on that one. And now Jeff Hardy going after Venom, and whoa, what a alley-oop facebuster by Jeff Hardy. Oh, but Venom right back up to his feet and some big right hands. And now look at the strength of L just launching Chris Jericho. And now look at this, setting up for a dropkick. Oh, dropkick right to the face. And now Venom going for that double tap springboard cross body on Jeff Hardy. Jeff Hardy in trouble. And now Venom on the cover. One, two, almost eliminated Jeff right there, but he got out of it. Oh, but got caught. Oh, a big power slam and a neck breaker. And Jeff wisely rolling out of the way. And L just continuing to punish Chris Jericho. And Venom taunting. Not very smart. Oh, nice cross body by L. Nice springboard. And again, bodies flying all over the place. Shot to the midsection. And a big punch to the face. And oh, what a knee. And a boot to the face. Into the cover. One, two. And a kick out at two by Jeff. One, two. Oh, but Chris Jericho gets the shoulder up. Again, this is going to be very tough to call. But man, what a flying knee by Venom. Oh, look at this. And the second whisper in the wind. And a big choke slam by Venom. Now into the cover off the whisper in the wind. One, but only a one count. And oh, dive. Oh, but missed him. Again, I'm already exhausted. And oh, nice swinging neck breaker. So much happening right now. People all over the place. And into the cover. One, two. Oh, that was close. Venom kicking out at two. And now look at this. Oh, what's Jeff doing here? Got Chris Jericho. Shot in the midsection. Going for a twist of fate. And twist of fate. Oh, no. Chris Jericho blocked it. Shoved him off. And now, oh, nice double leg takedown. Going for the walls of Jericho. There are pinfalls and submissions in this championship match. Oh, is Jeff Hardy going to tap out? Can he reach the Do ropes even count in this match? Oh, a big boot by Venom. But Jeff Hardy may be seconds away from submitting to Chris Jericho here. Can you imagine if Jeff Hardy loses to Chris Jericho again in this match? Man, that would be very infuriating for Jeff. You know, look at, but he got out of the walls of Jericho. Oh, a counter by Venom. Oh, L hangs on. But, oh, gets clotheslined right out of the ring. Brutal clothesline. On a counter by Jeff into a big back suplex on Chris Jericho. And now L firing back with, oh, a nice flying shoulder block or headbutt. I couldn't really tell what that was. And, oh, what a missile dropkick by Jeff Hardy on Chris Jericho into the cover. One, two. Oh, but Jericho kicks out at 2.5. Almost had him there off that missile dropkick. And going in the corner. And Venom back in the ring. And looks like L is on the outside just scouting, waiting for a perfect opportunity to strike. Oh, counter by Venom throwing into the ropes. Oh, but a counter by Jeff and a shot in the midsection. Man, these guys are going 100 miles per hour, and it's a lot of fun to watch. I'm not going to lie. And, missed the right hand. A big punch by L, and a big jumping elbow, and clothesline knocking Venom to the outside. And now Jeff Hardy, double springboard, but Jeff Hardy's connected. L's did not. L landed face first on the ground. Oh, what a drop kick right in the back of L's head. Now Jericho up against the rope, and L going back after Jeff Hardy. Ooh, knee right to the midsection. And now L setting up. Oh, look at the second rope diving. Elbow right to the midsection. And Chris Jericho right behind him. Oh, man, he could not go for the cover. Jericho right there. Oh, counter to a snapmare. And now look at this, L going for the cover. One, two, but a kick out at two. I think if he would have been able to get to that cover faster, we may have seen an elimination right there. Oh, a big jumping shoulder block by L. Oh, look at this. L and Jeff Hardy going after Jericho, and oh, double team gutbuster, both knees right to the midsection, but oh, L immediately going right back after Jeff, and big springboard by Chris Jericho. I'm very surprised that Jericho can still do stuff like that. Into the cover, one, two, he's like the Tom Cruise of wrestling. Despite how old he may get, he's still as just into it as ever. And now Jeff Hardy, oh, a beautiful Saito suplex right on the top of his head, and L again going after Jeff. Boy, what is L doing here? Oh, he's got him on the top rope. One L, springboard. Oh, Enziguri not sending Jeff Hardy flying. Oh, speaking of Enziguris, Chris Jericho with a big one right into the back of L's head. And these two continue to go at it. But a block and some right hands. Another one. Oh, got blocked. Oh, look at this counter. Look at this. And, oh, into a power bomb. And a lion salt. That might be it for L. Into the cover. One, two, but L gets the shoulder up at two. I thought that was it. And another Enziguri right to the back of the head again, trying to concuss the man, and a shot right to the arm. Man, Chris Jericho still in control. Both Venom and Jeff Hardy are out on the outside of the ring. Oh, a nice counter elbow right to the face. Might have got him in the nose. He's got him in the corner, big right hand to the face. And, oh, but I got countered with those feet right to the midsection. And now look at this old counter, throwing Jericho to the outside, but he hangs on. Oh, but gets dropkicked right in the mouth, sending him flying. And now L setting up for a high-risk maneuver. Might not be such a good idea. Oh my god, I got caught midair with a codebreaker. L is out. And a counter on the outside of the ring on the other side. Venom went for a chokeslam, but got countered into a DDT. Beautiful counter by Jeff Hardy. And Venom just taking a beating, but L might be out. If Chris Jericho can get L into the ring, L might be eliminated. But Jeff Hardy waiting on Venom to go back, get back to his feet. And a tope con hilo on Venom on the outside of the ring. And it looks like Chris Jericho's just chilling right next to the announce table, trying to pick his spot, I guess. It looks like he's watching these two fight from across the ring. And now Venom with a huge belly-to-belly suplex on Jeff Hardy. Man, right on the outside. There's not a lot of padding out there. Oh, now look at this. Always got him in a fireman's carry. And slamming him again back first on the outside. Again, not a lot of padding to protect from the cement on the outside. There's no give. And a chop right to the throat. And a boot right to the skull of Jeff Hardy. And Venom is in control of Jeff Hardy for the moment. And now Venom going to the top rope. And Venom got caught midair with a twist of fate. A lot of midair catches in this matchup. Oh, Venom is in serious trouble. He just got caught with a twist of fate. Uh-oh, Jeff Hardy. Oh, wait a second. Oh, gonna set up for the Swanton. Jeff Hardy with a Swanton bomb. Venom might be the first person eliminated. Now hooking the leg cover. One, two, three. Venom is eliminated. And Jericho going right after Jeff Hardy while his back was turned. But did not. Oh, counter. As soon as I say something. And now look at this going right to Jeff Hardy. That was a smart move by Jericho. He has L on the outside unconscious pretty much. And now he's going after Jeff Hardy after he eliminated Venom. I'm very surprised that Venom is the first person eliminated. And look at this top rope Frankensteiner. Jeff Hardy in a world of trouble. Very smart move by Jericho to wait on him. Now Jericho trying to build up some momentum. And a lion salt. Beautiful lion salt by Chris Jericho. An up wrap setting up for the codebreaker. Setting up for the code breaker, perhaps. Can he eliminate Jeff Hardy right here? Oh, look at this. Oh, no, wait. Went for the twist of fate, but got countered. He tried to steal Jeff Hardy's move, and Jeff does not appreciate it. Look at this, setting up for a, oh, gore buster right in the center of the ring. Well, not the center ring, right next to the center of the ring, but a beautiful sit out gore buster. And now Jeff perhaps setting up for the Swanton Bomb again. And what? Who the heck is that? Jacob Cass? Really? Attacking Jeff Hardy from behind. There's no disqualifications in this matchup. But Chris Jericho's protege from XAW, Jacob Cass, coming out of the ring to interfere. Are you kidding me? I get that this was part of their arrangement, but really? Are you serious? Oh no, look at this, setting up and a double team. Oh, a high low, big clothesline, just almost decapitating Jeff Hardy. This is so unfair. Oh wait, look at this. Oh, and Jacob Cass taking after his mentor, I guess, with a humongous code breaker. And I think that busted Jeff Hardy wide open. This is absolutely ridiculous. But I shouldn't be that surprised. But Jacob Cass here on the main roster. Oh, look at this. Oh, and another code breaker. This time by Jericho. And into the cover on Jeff. 1, 2, 3. You've got to be kidding me. We're down to 2. Oh, from behind, Kurt Mason. Kurt Mason coming to make the save and attack Jacob Cass, evening the odds. That's Aris Williams' pick for XAW. Kurt Mason attacking him. Oh, look at this. Oh, Jacob's in trouble. Jacob Cass just got a jackhammer on the outside. That's what I'm talking about. Oh, and Chris Jericho's irate. Oh, and L from behind with a big clothesline. That distracted Chris Jericho momentarily. And now L, boy, what is this? And oh my God, a snapmare driver. Now it could be an end of the cover. 1, 2, 3, and L has won the TAW Excalibur Championship. A huge thank you to Kurt Mason. Wow, what an unexpected turn of events, and a beautiful snapmare driver. Beautiful move by L, taking advantage of that opportunity. And hey, I was right. L has won this Fatal 4-Way Elimination match and is the new TAW Excalibur Champion, with a little assist from Kurt Mason taking care of Jacob Cass and distracting Chris Jericho. The wrong has been righted, in my opinion, and we have a new Excalibur champion, and L can turn in that title whenever he wants for a TAW championship opportunity. A huge win for L, and he hasn't even been in TAW for that long. He's already winning championships. But man, what a fatal four-way matchup. But up next, ladies and gentlemen, is another four competitors, but this is a tag team femme fatale matchup. And this mainly is a rivalry between Samara Morgan and She-Hulk, with Kyoko from The Grudge and Storm also in here for this tag team matchup. This is the first of two femme fatale matchups on this show. The other one is a femme fatale triple threat championship match. But here we go with Samara Morgan and Kyoko versus She-Hulk and Storm. And it looks like, from the looks of it, Samara and Kyoko are making their entrance together. The Sisters of Destruction. Clever, I guess. honestly, when you look at the two, I did not expect anything less than the Sisters of Destruction. The Japanese versions of these two were actually in a movie together, a Japanese movie, where they fought each other, and they slammed into each other so hard, they like fused into one. It's super bizarre, but it's absurdly entertaining. Go watch that. It's like Sadako versus Kyoko, the movie, The Grudge versus The Ring. It actually exists. I'm not lying. This is an actual movie that actually exists. It's very, very interesting. But this whole thing started when She-Hulk pretty much challenged Samara Morgan to a matchup, and Samara won. She-Hulk's never been able to let go of that loss and keeps attacking Samara Morgan. And now Kyoko and Storm have been brought into the mix, and here we go with a tag team matchup. Man, the Sisters of Destruction, very catchy. I like that. I like it very much. So I guess that means Samara is the Undertaker, which makes sense, and Kyoko is Kane? Don't really see that one, but sure, why not? And here comes She-Hulk. Her excuse for all of this is that Samara is evil, and she's a superhero, so the superhero's got to do whatever she can do to eliminate evil. I can kind of see where she's going with that. I mean, Samara has murdered people, but still, this is a wrestling show. So I think She-Hulk, I don't know if I agree with her motivation or her ideals. So I think she's just using that as an excuse to go after Samara because I think she's just jealous because Samara defeated her that one time, and it's a bit of an like, how can the all-powerful She-Hulk lose a match? She's She-Hulk, for goodness sake. She shouldn't be losing matches. But yeah, that's just my opinion. And here comes her tag team partner Storm from the X-Men. Now, Storm faced off against Samara Morgan on two separate occasions. One ended in disqualification because of She-Hulk interference. But the second time was when Kyoko came out of the ring to even the odds and allowed Samara to defeat Storm with the Tombstone Piledriver. I believe it was on the last episode of TAW Rivals. And an interesting thing about this match, this is the, I guess, in-ring debut of Kyoko. So I guess we'll have to see how she does in this matchup here. The Ring and the Grudge teaming up against the X-Men and She-Hulk. Very interesting matchup. You'd think that the Sisters of Destruction would be the bad guys and superheroes would be the good guys, but oh, but starting a matchup with a big flying clothesline. Yeah, Samara and She-Hulk kind of hate each other, so not very surprised that they'd be flying right out of the gates. And oh, nice stun gun right there. Now Samara going to the top rope with a big flying clothesline. Another one taking She-Hulk down. And now going right after the clavicles with those elbow strikes. At least I think those are the clavicles. I'm not a doctor, so I don't really know. But I assume that those are the clavicles. But a big bicycle kick right to the face. Now, She-Hulk is throwing another one. She-Hulk has actually pinned people with that bicycle kick before. But Samara just took two, and she's still on her feet. And, oh, a big headbutt by She-Hulk. So, yeah, that should tell you how tough Samara is. Oh, look at this. Went for a clothesline, but Storm ducked it. And now, oh, big right hand. And now a front chancery. Oh, missed a knee. Oh, missed a big bicycle kick. And a running bulldog by Samara Morgan. Nice counter by Samara. Now going after the arm. I would go, if I was fighting She-Hulk, I'd go after the leg. But I would never fight She-Hulk because I'm not stupid. Because I'm me. I don't have any powers or anything. And now tag made to Kyoko. And now this is our first look at her in TAW. We already know she can pull off a sick DDT and a double flapjack. Nice double team move right there. And, ooh, shot right to the back with that big kick right to the back. And now Kyoko is in command of She-Hulk right now. Oh, but got caught. Irish whip into the corner. And She-Hulk perhaps going to tag. Tag made to Storm. You know, this double team. Oh, an unprotected shot right to the stomach. And now look at this. No, went for Samara, but Samara moved out of the way. And She-Hulk went flying to the outside. Not Storm's smartest moment. And now, I guess, double team, gut buster, both knees right to the midsection, and Storm is in enemy territory right now. Oh, and look at this, setting up for a double Russian leg sweep, the back of Storm's head bouncing off the ground. Man, she better be very thankful that she did not hit the guardrail, because that would have been lights out. And that's actually a Raven move, the Russian leg sweep into the barricade, so. And now, some shots right to the leg. Oh, but Storm moving out of harm's way. But she's right there, right out of the frying pan into the fire. She got out of the ring to escape Kyoko, but ran right into Samara. That was kind of funny. But a nice running bulldog by Storm, trying to regain control of the match. Now some strikes. Oh, a big roundhouse kick right to the face. And it looks like Storm has taken control of this matchup. And now Kyoko in a lot of trouble. Kyoko needs to tag out here. Now some more kicks. Oh, but look at this, fighting back with some kicks of her own. Oh, missed that big spinning wheel kick. But back to her feet. And oh, it went for another kick, but again got blocked. And now Storm with some more kicks. Got caught. And oh, big clothesline. This is turning into a straight-up brawl, ladies and gentlemen. And I'm enjoying all of it. Oh, and a swinging neckbreaker by Kyoko. That might be it. Into the cover of that swinging neckbreaker. Hook in the leg. One, two, but only a two count. That was close. Almost had her there. Now some strikes. But again, some more strikes. Oh, look at this. Oh, big round. That was an even harder roundhouse kick after catching Kyoko's foot just to try to knock her head off with that big roundhouse. And now tag made to She-Hulk. And now just going to town on Kyoko. Kyoko needs to make a tag right now. You know, look at this arm wringer. Oh, what a headbutt. What a vicious headbutt. But that may have just made Kyoko mad. Oh, but look at this. And oh, now a nice chop block right there, trying to take her leg out. And Samara trying to do what she can from the apron, but not really working. And now a nice, smart move by She-Hulk, getting out of enemy territory, back to her own corner. And a tag made to Storm. And now look at the setting. Oh, she's got her arm exposed. And oh, an axe handle right to the elbow, trying to break her arm. But this time, the spear works. Oh, but left herself wide open. And Kyoko setting up for a vicious DDT, spiking Storm on the top of her head. Into the cover, hooking the leg. That might be it. One, Two ball, but She-Hulk breaks it up. That was close. Good tag team partner, though, and now just brutalizing Kyoko with a nice Hurricane Rana. A big double team move right there by Storm and She-Hulk. And now, again, a lot of trouble, but Storm has the momentum on her side. And an Irish whip into the corner. Perhaps going to make a tag. Tag made to She-Hulk. And again, Kyoko, oh, look at this. Oh, an assisted crossbody. Can you imagine seeing She-Hulk come flying at you and land right on your ribcage? I imagine that's very painful. But Kyoko needs to make a tag soon. Or now. Well, look at this. She-Hulk with a springboard clothesline. Man, it might be only a matter of time here. And into the cover, hooking the leg. One, two. But again, Kyoko kicks out of it. She's still in this matchup. Shot of the midsection. Oh, went for a kick, but got countered into a Frankensteiner. One, two. But a kick out at two by She-Hulk. Man, again, she needs to tag out. And, oh, a big drop kick. Oh, but look, she's right there. Finally makes the tag to Samara Morgan, who's back in this matchup. And what an uppercut. Oh, look at this. Running wild. And an elbow knocking Storm off the apron. Now, look at this. She-Hulk's dazed. Oh, Samara got her hand around the throat. And a big choke slam. Humongous choke slam. Into the cover hook in the leg. That might be it. One, two. Oh, but She-Hulk kicks out at two. Man, it's going to take so much to put her down for the count. Oh, but missed a knee. Look at this. Oh, big axe handle knocking Samara down, just destroying all of that momentum she had built up. And now Samara in trouble, and She-Hulk throwing her to the outside, but she hangs on. Oh, but maybe it would have done better for her to just fall to the outside and just getting clubbed right in the sternum. Just repeated strikes by She-Hulk right in the face and sternum. And oh my god, that was like, what, 9 or 10? Just brutal. And Samara landing face first on the outside. Man, and the referee counting. And look at this, throwing her back in the ring. Storm over there for support. And a shot to the face. And, oh, a big boot right to the face again. And She-Hulk is in control, for the moment at least. And look at this, She-Hulk. What's she going to do here? Oh, look at this. And, oh, a springboard shoulder block. Nice move by She-Hulk. Very impressive agility. I'm very surprised. Now going to the top rope. She-Hulk. Diving. Oh, but got caught midair by Samara Morgan. Right into Tombstone Pile Driver. That's got to be it. But Kyoko getting in the ring and taking out Storm into the cover. One, two, three. And Storm and She-Hulk have been defeated. Kyoko and Samara Morgan with a victory. And Kyoko's debut performance is a successful one. What a good tag team match between these two Femme Fatale tag teams. Very impressive performance by these two. I'm very impressed with Kyoko and Samara Morgan. Samara Morgan continuing her path of destruction here tonight at TAW Aftershock. And we will be right back after the break. Remember the old TAW podcast?
That ended off the...
Well, kiss it goodbye, because the Totally Awesome Podcast has been redone in a whole new way. Check out the new TAP on Podbean and Spotify for the latest episodes, where Josh Geddon and various guests discuss pro wrestling.
The cover of USA Today once was David Arquette wins a world title. Is there any newspapers out there going, hey, some random 10-year-old piece of shit won the title? I'm sorry.
And generally act really stupid for an unspecified period of time. So
I love you, Joshua!
I love you too, Mr. Perfect Einstein!
Visit the worst podcast you've ever heard today. All right, up next, ladies and gentlemen, is the Last Chance Molecular Championship match, Dracula defending the Molecular Championship against Deadpool. And again, this is the last chance for Deadpool. If Deadpool loses this matchup, he will not be able to challenge Dracula again for the Molecular Championship as long as Dracula is champion. So, like, if someone else beats Dracula for the title, then Deadpool will be able to challenge for that belt again. But as long as Dracula holds it, he won't be able to challenge for it again if he loses tonight. Because these two have clashed numerous times over the Molecular title, but Dracula has always defeated Deadpool. They've had numerous matches against each other, like at Crash Course when they were both involved in the Crash Course match, Dracula eliminated Deadpool, then he beat him in a one-on-one non-title match, then he defeated him on TAW Rivals for that title, and they had a match at No Escape, and Dracula won again. And in that fatal four-way matchup at Riot Central 2 that involved Gohan and Freddy Krueger, again Dracula was victorious. And he's been a great Molecular champion. But he keeps beating Deadpool, but Deadpool won a number one contenders match. He defeated Gohan and Freddy Krueger in a triple threat number one contenders ladder match to become the challenger for the Molecular title. But again, this is his final opportunity. He cannot let it slip through his fingers tonight, because if he does, he will not be able to challenge Dracula for it anymore as long as Dracula is champion. So, big stakes in this matchup. This is a Molecular championship. it's on the line, ladies and gentlemen. And, yeah, you gotta feel for Deadpool. It's gotta be so frustrating. Deadpool was a great Molecular champion, and then he lost it to Dracula. I believe he lost it to him in 2016, and Dracula has been a great champion, but Deadpool has had numerous opportunities, but he keeps coming up short. And if that happens again tonight, then that's gonna be all. He'll have to go to the very back of the line. He won't even be eligible for the line anymore, so... hopefully that won't happen, because again, big Deadpool fan, but I gotta be unbiased. But taking away the unbiasedness, is that even a phrase? I'm a fan of Deadpool, not so much of Dracula, so it would really suck to see that happen to Deadpool. Maybe if he loses tonight, he'll go after a different championship. Because, I mean, after a while, you gotta say enough's enough. But again, this is his final opportunity. And he is a former Molecular champion, so he's got it done in the past. But can he defeat Dracula here tonight? That is the question. He's never been able to do it. Will the Dracula streak over Deadpool continue, or will Deadpool finally overcome? And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. The second biggest championship in TAW, the Molecular Championship, held by William Wallace and Deadpool, and now Dracula, is on the line in this Last Chance Championship match. Man, I am very excited for this, because and remember the last several times they were one-on-one, Dracula was victorious. Especially last time they were on pay-per-view 1-1-1, it was at No Escape and Dracula won. But here we go. Can Deadpool finally get it done? And there it is, ladies and gentlemen, handing the belt to our the official Alfred, who's calling all of our matches tonight. man, he is an overworked referee, let me tell you. And there we go, ladies and gentlemen, the Molecular Championship on the line. And the match has begun. And here we go. And right out of the gate, not looking good for Deadpool. He tried to charge Dracula, but ran right into a spinning heel kick right in the face. And Dracula immediately in control. And with a nice swinging neck breaker, I think it's safe to say that Dracula has Deadpool's number. This already does not bode well for Deadpool. But Deadpool firing back with a big running drop kick right in the face. He's going to have to keep sticking and moving. Big clothesline by Deadpool. And, oh, a big elbow to the face. And another spinning heel kick, this time completely taking Deadpool off his feet. And again, I don't want to count Deadpool out, but Dracula has his number. It's tough to argue that. But Deadpool firing back. You know he's not going to give up. Well, went for a knee strike, but got blocked. Now going for an arm wringer. He's got his own old shot right to the elbow. Nice move. If you take away the arms, he won't be able to do big boot right to the face. If you take away Dracula's arms, he won't be able to do Devil's Wings, his finishing maneuver. Oh, look at this. Oh, Deadpool setting up for a springboard. Springboard clothesline knocking down the Molecular Champion. Nice move by Deadpool. And a shot in the midsection, setting up for that big knee and a knee to the face. And Deadpool starting to get into this matchup, finally starting to take an advantage over Dracula in this match. Oh, look at this. Springboard. Oh, big springboard roundhouse kick. Beautiful move. And into the cover hook in the leg. One... but only a one count. Big kick right to the face, only gets a one. That's got to be frustrating. Oh, nice trip by Dracula. Smart move and a big punch right to the face. And the Molecular Champion setting up for a superplex. And a huge superplex by Dracula, turning the tide in this matchup right to the back of Deadpool. But Deadpool right back up. Oh, but runs right into an Irish whip. And oh, a big dropkick, and it looks like Dracula's going to be focusing on the back of Deadpool in this match, the midsection. Now throwing him across the ring, and another dropkick, this time right to the face. Yeah, Alfred, you might want to move out of the way. If I was the referee and I saw a vampire coming at me with a dropkick, I'd probably move out of the way. But Deadpool the counter with a big right hand to the face, but got caught on using his leg strength. And it looks like his back isn't that hurt. Oh, and oh, a nice dropkick right to the knee. Dracula trying to egg him on, that might not have been very smart. And now just, oh, big boot right to the face. Dropkick, both feet right to, it looked like both feet hit both cheeks of Dracula right in the face. And an Irish whip and a beautiful Samoan drop using all of that momentum and leverage, just planting Dracula. And Deadpool not going for the pin. Wait, setting up. And a second one, an even more devastating Samoan drop. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. And it looks like Deadpool is in control. And now Deadpool, oh wait, setting up perhaps for that Famouser. And Deadpool with a beautiful Famouser, sending Dracula's face right into the canvas, but not going for a pin. He usually goes for the pin off of that. Oh wait, perhaps setting up for a diving Famouser. And look at this, Deadpool with a diving Famouser. That might be it. We might have a new champion right here. Into the cover, hooking the leg. One, two, oh, two and a half. That was so close. Deadpool almost winning the Molecular Championship. And if Deadpool wins this match, he will be the first ever two-time Molecular Champion. But move that out of the way, that spinning heel kick. And now Dracula setting up. Oh, look at this. Using some strength into a huge sidewalk slam. Just planting him back first. Again, Dracula going after the midsection of Deadpool here. Now setting up for that. Oh, nice running neck twist. Just a little bit of whiplash. But Deadpool again firing back with those powerful legs. And now look at this. But runs into another spinning heel kick. Speaking of powerful legs. And now he's got him up. And a big headbutt. And look at this. And a regal cutter. Nice move by Dracula. So smooth. Into the cover hook in the leg. One, two, but only a two count. Deadpool getting the shoulder up. But a shot at the midsection. Deadpool, oh, what's he going for? Perhaps that pump stool or pile driver. And oh, spiking him right on the top of his head. Vicious impact. Perhaps going to go for the cover. Dragging away from the ropes. No, wait. Oh, wait a second. Going to the top rope. What's Deadpool doing here? And, oh, both feet right to the midsection off the double stomp. Into the cover. One, two. Oh, Dracula again just barely surviving. Man, so many times Deadpool's been so close to beating Dracula. But again, does not get the job done. Oh, believe this. Dracula was off the second rope with a beautiful moonsault. So athletic. Into the cover. One, two. But again, Deadpool stays alive. It's so impressive to me that he's able to do a moonsault like that wearing what he's wearing. Look at his outfit. It must be very uncomfortable to wrestle in that, let alone do a moonsault. That's impressive. It's why Dracula's champion. And he's a former hardcore champion as well. He was the first ever TAW hardcore champion. But Deadpool back on his feet. Oh, look at this. And a Frankensteiner by Dracula. I don't think I've ever seen him do that before. Pulling out all the stops in this match. Oh, but look at this. Deadpool with a big shoulder block. Setting up for the, five moves of... Gosh dang it, Deadpool. Really? But trying to build momentum, and a nice, oh, nice side suplex right there, and Deadpool building momentum against Dracula. And now Dracula, oh, look at this, Deadpool setting up for another pile driver, this time a regular one. Oh, and the pile driver connects, again drilling Dracula, and into the cover. One, two, oh, again, so close, but still so far away from winning the title. But runs right into a flapjack, beautiful counter by Dracula. Every time Deadpool gets something going, Dracula cuts him off. And that's pretty much been the story of all of their matches. Deadpool with a flurry, Dracula with a counter. But he's got him back up, and look at this. Oh, fireman's carry. What's Dracula going to do here? Oh, a second flapjack. Man, two brutal flapjacks right to the face. And now Dracula with a big forearm right to the jaw. And Dracula is back in control. He's got him back on his feet and a big right hand. Oh, but caught his foot. Oh, another counter, this time by Deadpool. And now Deadpool throwing Dracula into the corner. What's Deadpool going to do here? Wait. Oh, he may be setting up for a superplex. Or perhaps that brainbuster. Oh, this is the move he used to win the Molecular Championship from William Wallace at Decadence. Can he connect with it? And Deadpool with a... Oh, my God. That move is so vicious. Brutal brainbuster into the cover. One, two. Oh, and again a kick out. Near fall after near fall in this championship match. What does Deadpool have to do to put Dracula away? But, oh, a counter with a big forearm to the face. And now Dracula going to the top rope. And a diving elbow smash right to the face. Man, and look at this. Dracula, Irish whip. And, oh, trying to knock him out of the ring, but he hangs on. Oh, wait a second. I'm still surprised Dracula survived that brainbuster. But now Dracula with an, oh, an apron DDT. Speaking of spiking him headfirst, right into the apron, the hardest part of the ring. And look at that. Oh, a big elbow drop right to the midsection that Dracula's been working on in this entire match. And now just throwing him right into the announce table. I'm surprised we haven't seen the announce table get broken so far tonight. It's going to happen. It's a wrestling show. Of course, the announce table is going to get broken. And now Dracula with some more strikes. And some more right hands. Oh, but let's get caught. Oh, my God. He got caught with a Samoan drop right into the steel chairs. Man, that was sickening impact right there. That was devastating. And honestly, Deadpool needed that to get back in this matchup because he was looking a little bit out of it after that apron DDT. And now big right hand by Deadpool. And now it looks like he's in control once again. And look at this. Oh, but a counter by Dracula. And Dracula on the top rope. What's this? Oh, in front missile dropkick, but Deadpool saw it coming and moved out of the way. And now Deadpool going for some kicks, some shots right to the back. Man, Deadpool, this is honestly getting to the point where you start running out of moves. He's got to go for the Weapon X headlock driver if he wants to win this matchup. And Dracula, of course, is going to have to go for the Devil's Wings. Neither competitor has gone for the finishing move yet. And now nice stun gun by Deadpool. And again, trying to maintain the momentum in this matchup. Deadpool, you can see he's trying to figure out what to do here. And all this from behind. Oh, dear God. Oh, my God! An inverted suplex. That was an inverted superplex from the apron to the outside. Too bad this is not false count anywhere, because this match would be over. What a brutal move by Deadpool, pulling out all the stops. He knows this is his final opportunity, and he's trying to make the best of it. And I would go for the pinfall after that. Good Lord, that was vicious. But oh, a big dropkick, not just cutting him off. Nice move by Dracula. Oh, but a counter shot to the face with a boot. And look at this diving. Oh, but got caught. And into a powerbomb. Beautiful counter by Dracula. That's why he's a molecular champion. Into the cover. One, two, and again, Deadpool stays alive. These two cannot put each other away in this matchup. And oh, went for that discus forearm, but got caught. Oh, look at this off the catch. Look at this, setting up for a suplex. Into a DDT. Nice move by Deadpool. And perhaps setting up. If Deadpool can turn this into the Weapon X headlock driver, we'll have a new champion. Oh, he's setting up, perhaps going for the Weapon X. Oh, he's got him. Oh, no, Tombstone Piledriver, Tombstone. Oh, wait a second. Dracula kicking, shifting the momentum into a Tombstone Piledriver of his own. This is exactly how he defeated Deadpool to win the molecular title. He countered the Tombstone Piledriver and is now setting up for the Angel's Wings. Nope. Oh, but a counter knee to the midsection by Deadpool, and off that knee. Oh, here he goes, Weapon X, and it connects, just spiking Dracula headfirst into the canvas. Will that be it? Into the cover. One, two, three, and Deadpool has finally defeated Dracula. We have a new molecular champion. Deadpool finally getting that monkey off his back. Wow, what a matchup between these two. Deadpool is now a two-time TAW molecular champion, finally defeating Dracula after so many failures. This was his final opportunity, and boy did he seize it. And man, I'm so impressed with Deadpool right now, finally defeating Dracula to become the first ever two-time molecular champion. What a night for the Merc with the Mouth. He's got to be so happy right now. I mean, Vanessa, get ready for one heck of a night, because he's probably gonna I'm just gonna stop with that sentence. But up next, ladies and gentlemen, our second Femme Fatale matchup. The Femme Fatale Championship is on the line in a triple threat matchup. Lara Croft defending the championship against the Statue of Liberty and Android 18 in a triple threat matchup. Now, of course, there are pinfalls and submissions in this match. First pinfall or submission wins the match. And there are no countouts or disqualifications in this matchup. So no champion's advantage. And of course, this whole thing started before Riot Central 2, when Statue of Liberty and Android 18 were feuding, but Lara Croft won the Femme Fatale Championship at Riot Central 2 by winning a Fatal 4-Way Tables, Ladders, and Chairs match in against Statue of Liberty, Android 18, and Sophie Kane. So, that was one heck of a match, but when she went to defend the title against the Statue of Liberty, Android 18 interrupted, causing a double disqualification, leading into this triple threat matchup. Because everyone in this match, Lara Croft is the current champion. Android 18 and the Statue of Liberty are both former Femme Fatale champions. And a very interesting fact about this match. This is not the first time these three have fought each other in a standard triple threat matchup for the Femme Fatale title. They fought each other in the main event of TAW Action, I think about almost a year ago. and it was the Android 18 defending the Femme Fatale title against Statue of Liberty and Lara Croft, and the Statue of Liberty won that matchup. So, Statue of Liberty, I honestly believe, has the advantage in this championship match. I mean, just look at her. She's a freaking Leviathan. She's absolutely gigantic. She demolishes people, and she's won a triple threat match against these two before. So, I honestly think that the Statue of Liberty has a huge advantage in this matchup. Now, Lara Croft has a lot of momentum, and Android 18 is her usual devious Android 18 self. Probably see some shenanigans in this matchup. We've already seen shenanigans on this show, but would not be surprised to see more of it. But I think the chances of the Statue of Liberty doing a repeat performance is very likely tonight. We might see a new champion in this matchup. Wouldn't be the first time on this show we've seen a two-time champion. I mean, Deadpool just won the molecular title for the second time. I would not be surprised to see the Statue of Liberty, or Android 18 for that matter, win this matchup. And here comes our final competitor, another former Femme Fatale champion, Android 18, who almost retired Cammy in that brutal matchup at TIW Meltdown back in 2015, and then that equally brutal Hell in a Cell matchup at Crash Court. But again, she lost her Femme Fatale championship and has been aching to get it back, and she has another opportunity here tonight in this triple threat matchup. And ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be very interesting. And again, this is not the first time these three have met in a triple threat match. They met each other at Riot Central 2 in that Fatal 4-Way TLC match, which was also unbelievably brutal, where Statue of Liberty powerbombed Android 18 off a stage. So don't forget that. Don't forget that. But there it is, ladies and gentlemen. That's the prize, the TAW Femme Fatale Championship. And here we go. Triple threat action. And Statue of Liberty immediately starting off, spearing Lara Croft right out of her boots. Just immediately with a vit. Oh, look at this. Android 18 going for a cover. One, two, but immediately gets broken up by the Statue of Liberty. Trying to take advantage of that spear right out of the gate. I'm very impressed with the Statue of Liberty's tenacity here. Well, this double team going after 18 with a double suplex. Not very surprised because she did interfere in a championship match between the two. And it looks like they've decided that Android 18 is the common enemy. And look at this. Oh, an STO Russian leg sweep combo right there. That was nice. And Android 18 is in a lot of trouble, throwing her into the corner, and oh, but got kicked right in the face. Nice counter by Android 18. But oh, look at this, and 18, oh, super kick right to the jaw of the Statue of Liberty, and a nice kick by Lara Croft into the cover, taking advantage. Will this be it? One, two, but a kick out at two by the Statue of Liberty on Lara Croft. Wait, she's going for the Tomb Raider DDT this early? And the Tomb Raider DDT connects. Will that be it? But Android 18 right there trying to steal the pin, but Lara Croft's not going to let that happen. Man, Statue of Liberty got drilled right in the jaw with that super kick and then laid out with that, well, at least counter into a belly-to-belly suplex. I was about to say she got laid out with that in a big clothesline. Got laid out with Lara Croft's huge DDT. And now look at this. Android 18 going for the camel clutch trying to get a submission, but Lara Croft not going to let that happen. And this is not an elimination matchup. This is not like that Fatal 4-Way earlier. This is first pinfall or submission. And it's inside the ring. This is not a false count anywhere match. And now look at this. Oh, perhaps going for a double team on the champion here. And a double team gutbuster. Both knees right to the midsection. And this champion is in trouble. And Android 18 and the Statue of Liberty taunting. I'm not sure that's a very good idea. But whatever. And now throwing her into the corner. And also that, I think Lara Croft may have taken exception to that. And oh, a body splash to both of them in the corner. Lara Croft has been so impressive as of late, ever since she won the title. And now look at this front chancery, but a counter into a beautiful Russian leg sweep by Android 18. Nice counter. And now look at this, trying to drag her up so she can go for the cover. But again, Statue of Liberty trying to pry her off of her. But 18, like a pit bull, just will not release her grip. And now the Statue of Liberty going after 18 again, but got caught with a beautiful, oh my god, what a spine buster by Android 18. Beautiful Arn Anderson spine buster. With pretty much no momentum. Oh my god! Android 18 just got launched right into my announce table. Just went flying face first into it. Back in the ring, a nice bulldog by the Statue of Liberty. What is the Statue of Liberty going to have to do to win the championship in this matchup here? But 18 back in the ring. Went for a right hand and an oh, big knee drop by the Statue of Liberty. Never a dull moment in triple threat matches like this. And now look at this. Oh, what a clothesline! An absolutely vicious and malicious clothesline by Android 18. Trying to decapitate Lara Croft, and now an elbow right to the face. And now look at this, 18 going to the top rope, but decides against it. Smart move. pulling the Statue of Liberty with some knees right in the midsection, and Laura Croft has a steel chair. Oh, the steel chair is live, and look at the athleticism of 18, but she moved out of the way. And an own STO, and a chair right to the face of the Statue of Liberty. Desperate times call for desperate measures as far as Laura Croft is concerned. And just wearing out that chair. Now she's got it propped up in the corner. Oh, this is not going to go well for someone's cranium. Oh, no. And, oh, 18 face first into the chair in the corner. Brutal move. And now look at the Statue of Liberty setting up for a pump handle slam, and it connects. This is the Statue of Liberty's opportunity here. But not able to go for a cover. 18 back on her feet. She's got to be a little dazed from that chair shot right there. Oh, but a counter by Laura Croft. Punch her into the face. Oh, but a counter, double leg takedown. But I don't think she saw 18 get back up. 18 immediately breaking that up. Oh, no, look at this side headlock. Oh, and that nice hip toss takedown right there by Android 18. Oh, but Laura Croft from behind setting up for an Alabama slammer and connects. The whiplash on that is just absolutely devastating. And now Laura Croft, oh wait, what is this? Look at the strength into an electric chair with a bridge. 1, 2, oh, but a kick out at 2.5. I thought she had it there for a split second. What an innovative move right there by Laura Croft, a bridging electric chair. Oh, but got caught, and oh, dear God, look at the Statue of Liberty with a fall-away slam from the second rope. That might be it. Only a shot of the midsection, and paying Android 18 back with a spinebuster of her own. Oh, this is Statue of Liberty's opportunity here. Can she go for the cover? And now into the cover, hooking the leg. New champion, 1, 2. Oh, but 18 gets the shoulder up at 2. That was close. And oh, a nice shoulder block knocking her down. There's Laura Croft again trying to take her out. And a big dropkick sending the Statue of Liberty flying to the outside of the ring. And I think she landed really hard on the outside. And now it looks like Laura Croft is going to try to take advantage of that spinebuster. Got Android 18 all to herself. And now she's got her on the top rope. What's she going to go for here? Oh, but got countered with a kick right to the chest. And Android 18 going for a blockbuster. Oh, but got caught with a power slam in midair. Very impressive. Into the cover. 1, 2. But Android 18 kicks out at 2. That was close. Almost had her right there. Now throwing her to the outside, but she just barely hangs on. And look at this. Oh, counter. And an elbow forearm right to the face. And Android 18 springboard. This time, she connects with the Overcastle. Oh, and she's not done yet. Setting up for a 450 splash. That might be an end of the cover. 1, 2. Oh, that was close. Android 18 almost became a two-time Femme Fatale champion. Oh, but got caught into a... Oh, Tilt-A-Whirl sidewalk slam. Nice counter by the current Femme Fatale champion. And these two are just turning up the intensity, ladies and gentlemen. This has been a very intense matchup. Oh, what a counter, but she hangs on. And look at this, 18 with a big dropkick right to the face, sending her to the outside. And what is Android 18 setting up for here? And Android 18 with a 450 to the outside. My God. High risk, high reward. And again, the Statue of Liberty still out by the table. Oh, look at this, Android 18. Oh, steel steps right to the skull. Trying to bust Laura Croft open. Again, it's too bad this is not a false count anywhere match, because that might have sealed the deal right there. Oh no. Oh, and oh, the power blitz on the steel steps. Goodbye hips, ladies and gentlemen. That was devastating. Oh, look at this. Oh, and hey, oh, and Statue of Liberty with a spear as soon as 18 got back in the ring. Can that be it? Into the cover. 1, 2. Oh, but a near fall. Android 18 just barely getting the shoulder up. That was a very intelligent move by the Statue of Liberty, waiting for the exact moment to strike with that vicious spear. And it almost won her the championship. Oh, and a clubbing shot to the back of the head. This matchup continues, ladies and gentlemen. But I think the Statue of Liberty, oh, this might be her best opportunity here. Oh, look at this sidewalk slam from the top rope. Beautiful move. Oh, and not done yet. Not done yet with a diving splash into the cover. 1, 2. And again, Android 18 survives it. But I think Laura Croft is hurt on the outside from that absolutely vicious power blitz. Oh, look at this. Oh, setting up for the Liberty Bomb, her finishing maneuver. Oh, but a counter into a DDT. Beautiful counter by Android 18. She's felt that move before. And into a power blitz. That's it. New champion. Cover 1, 2. No, the Statue of Liberty gets the shoulder up. She survived the power blitz. Oh, and Android 18 is absolutely furious. Oh, wait. Perhaps it's going to set up for... If she connects with another one, that's it. And here we go. Oh, but she went for it, but it got countered by the Statue of Liberty. Almost had her there. Look at this Irish whip. And look at this, going for a huge black hole slam by the Statue of Liberty. And I would go for the pin off of that, but I don't think the Statue of Liberty's done just yet. Oh, but a counter by 18, and a shot right to the midsection. And look at this. And, a beautiful kick right to the face. And now look at this, 18. What's 18 going to go for here? Only setting up for a German. And look at that German suplex. The strength of Android 18 just launching the Statue of Liberty across the ring. Olga's 450 splash. No, but this time it did not connect. She went to it for it a third time, but that time it was not the charm. Statue of Liberty saw it coming and moved right out of the way. And look, this time the strength of the Statue of Liberty into a military press slam, trying to break Android 18 in half. But again, she's going to have to go for the Liberty Bomb. Oh, well, perhaps setting it. Oh, what a counter. And into the ropes. And 18 with a beautiful Arn Anderson Spinebuster. Another one. And off that Spinebuster, setting up for a standing moonsault. Nice move by 18. Got to go for a cover there while the champion is out on the outside of the ring. Oh, but a block. And a big right hand. And now look at the shot of the midsection. And another Spinebuster. It's a battle of the Spinebusters in this matchup between these two. Just trying to beat the crap out of each other. All for the Femme Fatale title. And look at this. Now going for another sidewalk slam. This time in the middle of the ring. Again, I would go for a pinfall. Got her back up. Oh, but a counter knee to the midsection by Android 18. Oh, look at this. Oh, what a backbreaker. A Russian leg sweep into a backbreaker. And now just flying knees right to the top of the head of the Statue of Liberty. These two are just beating the crap out of each other. Oh, look at this. Setting up for another German suplex. Android 18 just tossing the Statue of Liberty around the ring. Oh, look at this. Setting up for another one. Oh, another German, but keeps the hands locked. And a second German suplex. Can she go for the triple? And the triple German suplex connects. And the Statue of Liberty is in a world of trouble right now. Picking her back up, though. Android 18 going for an Irish whip into the ropes. What's this? Oh, look at this. Oh, Statue of Liberty countered it into a DDT. I didn't know she was that agile. That was very surprising. What a counter by the Statue of Liberty. Oh, this Irish whip into the ropes. And a pop-up into a spear. What a move by the Statue of Liberty. I don't think I've ever seen that before. And oh no. She can honestly pin her right now, but she's not satisfied. Wants to finish her off with a Liberty Bomb. This is exactly how it went down in their previous triple threat match. Oh, just setting up for the Liberty Bomb. And it connects, but Laura Croft getting back in the ring from behind with another German to the Statue of Liberty. Can't she capitalize? Laura into the cover, shooting the half. One, two, three. And Laura Croft takes full advantage of the Liberty Bomb. Laura Croft is still the TAW Femme Fatale champion in an absolutely vicious triple threat matchup. Laura Croft picking her spot. Her back has still got to be sore from that power blitz on the steel steps, but Laura Croft in her first pay-per-view title defense is victorious and is still the TAW Femme Fatale champion, but I do not think that this is going to sit very well with Android 18 or the Statue of Liberty, but for tonight, Laura Croft can celebrate here at TAW Aftershock. But up next, ladies and gentlemen, perhaps one of the more personal feuds here tonight. The Lightning Weight Championship is on the line in a First Blood matchup. It's the current champion, Mario, versus Luigi. And ladies and gentlemen, there are no pinfalls, no submissions, no countouts, and no disqualifications in this match. The only way to win is to bust your opponent wide open. This is the first ever First Blood match in TAW history. And it is for the Lightning Weight Championship. Mario defending against his brother Luigi. In a feud that's been going on since, honestly, 2014. Because remember, way back at Riot Central 1, Luigi took Mario out of action with a steel steps concerto. And then he went on a few years later to win the Lightning Weight title. And then Mario defeated Luigi for the Lightning Weight title at Riot Central 2 to get a little bit of revenge. But here we go tonight. Can Mario defeat his brother once again? And these two have had all sorts of matches against each other. They've had an unsanctioned match. They've had a steel cage match. They had that classic match at Riot Central 2. They've been involved in a triple threat match with Sonic the Hedgehog. Man, all sorts of crazy matches. And now a First Blood matchup. Very appropriate for these two. And another interesting factor, Elmo and the Cookie Monster, Luigi's friends, his tag team partners, are banned from ringside. If they show their faces, Luigi is he forfeits the match automatically. So Luigi has no one in his corner. However, he's still confident. He says he has a plan. I'm not entirely sure what that entails. I don't like the sound of it. But at least we know that the Sesame Street Posse is not going to be in his corner tonight. So it's just going to be a one-on-one, first person to bleed loses match. And this is going to be a bloodbath, ladies and gentlemen. I can already tell this is not going to end very pretty. This is going to be intense, ladies and gentlemen. I foresee a lot of weapon shots to the head. I think that's very reasonable to assume, since that's pretty much the goal of the match, to make your opponent bleed. Unless you, like, cut their arm open, but that wouldn't be as cool, to be perfectly honest. There's nothing like just seeing blood just stream down someone's face. But anyway, enough about that. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen, the next chapter of this rivalry. Mario and Luigi for the TAW Lightning Weight Championship. And here we go again, it's first blood rules. No pinfalls, no submissions, no countouts, and no disqualifications. Although the Sesame Street Posse is banned from ringside. What is going to go down in this matchup? And this is Mario's first pay-per-view title defense, his second defense against Luigi. He's already defeated Luigi once when he tried to find a loophole to win the title back, but Howard Stern thankfully reversed it. And here we go, Lightning Weight Championship on the line, first blood rules, this is going to be a fight. And here we go, oh, starting out, went for Hurricanrana, but I got countered. And now this front chancery, but another counter, an armbar, another counter into an arm drag. These two know each other very well. I mean, duh, they're brothers, and they've had numerous matches against each other, but another counter, went for an uppercut but missed it, and I was getting back up, and just a standoff right there. You know me, and I know you very well, and now throwing him into the corner. Oh, but a counter by Mario, throwing him into the corner, and another counter, ring around the Rosie, and oh, another counter! Oh, look at this! A nice Bronco Buster by Mario. I did not think that would be the first move in this matchup, only the springboard right into a Bulldog, and the first offense focused on the head and a dropkick right to the face. And honestly, should they have taken their hats off for this match so we can see if they're bleeding or not? But a beautifully athletic Hurricanrana takedown by Mario right there, and now throwing Luigi to the outside. And, oh, a kick to the face, but does not knock him off. And this time a dropkick, and this time Luigi goes flying. And again, oh, like a springboard. Oh man, what a bad landing for Mario. Luigi saw it coming, and a big kick right to the face. But man, he could have internal injuries from a landing like that. You gotta be careful, but he missed that kick. And now, oh, went for a spinning heel kick, but missed it. And another dodge. So many dodges. A lot of dodging in this matchup. Again, they've been wrestling each other numerous times, so they pretty much have each other figured out. You know, at least you would think. And a nice drop kick. And now Luigi seems to be in control right here. Oh, but a shot to the midsection. Oh, returning the favor. And a beautiful drop kick right to the face. Mario trying to get back into this matchup. And now look at this. What is Mario gonna do here? What's he got on his mind? And now, oh, throwing him right into the steel steps. Wouldn't be the first time we've seen steel steps used tonight. Oh, but look at this. Oh, Mario has a steel chair. That could split someone open instantly. And that might be just a one shot. That's it, ladies and gentlemen. That's the one thing about a first blood match. It can end at any moment. And they've both got kendo sticks. But, oh, Mario pulling the trigger first with a kendo stick right to the midsection. And, oh, went for a shot to the back. Oh, look at this. Oh, Luigi stealing the kendo stick. And look at this. Oh, he's got the chair. But Luigi returns the favor right to the midsection. And a shot right to the back of the head. But again, another shot right to the midsection. But again, got to go for the head. That's what they're going to be doing in this match. But it's not going to be like with Thanos and Thor. They've got to go for the head. You know I was going to get some kind of movie reference in here somewhere. But a nice takedown by Luigi. And more taunting. Not surprising at all. But Luigi going back outside the ring perhaps to get another weapon. Again, the name of the game is blood. And the referee is right there. He's got to call whoever he sees bleeding. He's got to call it. Oh, look at this. Oh, what a chair shot right to the head. If I was a referee, I would check him right now. Oh, but look at this. And, oh, the Van Marionator right there. Right to the face, but again, it does not look like it has busted Luigi open. Oh, but a counter into a tilt-a-whirl backbreaker right to the spine. Nice counter by Luigi, but that still had to ring his bell a little bit. But he's not busted open just yet. And we saw this in the previous match. Got that chair set up in the corner. That could easily bust someone open. I'll give us some more shots to the face. And now Luigi setting up for a beautiful snap suplex. And now looks like Luigi is in control. And going for another weapon. No, wait. Oh, he's setting up for the announce table. Oh, but wait. Mario from behind. What's Mario going to do here? Springboard. Going for another bulldog. And another springboard bulldog. This time to the outside. Where there's not a lot of padding. No give. And if you break your nose and start bleeding, that's it. Oh, but look at this. All setting up for the announce table. Oh, what's Luigi going to go for here? Oh, this is bad news for Mario here. And Luigi with a moonsault. Oh, Mario moved out of the way. And Luigi went crashing through the table. But he's back up. That had to do a number on his ribs. It's a good thing he didn't land face first on the table, because that could have busted him open right there. Now he's back in the ring. Oh, look at this, turning him around. Oh, look at this. Luigi has Mario up, pressing a power bomb. No, wait. And, oh, an alley-oop right into the trash can, cutting the trash can. And it's a wonder it did not bust Amari open. Now some straight shots right in the face, trying to bust him open, but it has not worked just yet. Now look at this, Luigi. Oh, went for a helo, but Mario saw it coming. I believe he landed on the trash can. Oh man, right to the midsection with that kendo stick, and oh, right to the back, just wearing him out with that kendo stick right to those overalls. Now he's got him back up. Oh, what is Mario gonna do here? What does Mario have on his mind? Oh, throwing him up into that chair that Luigi put up, face first into the chair, but it does not look like he's bleeding just yet. I do not think he's bleeding. Oh, but a counter and a shot to the leg, and oh, a big drop kick by Luigi right to the back, knocking Mario down. And I got a kendo stick, and went for a shot, but missed him. And oh man, he was gonna try to swing that at his head. Oh, look at this, another head scissors takedown by Mario. And now Mario again, the tide has turned once again. And now what is Mario gonna do here? Mario's gonna have to do something big here. What's he gonna do? Oh, we got countered with a knee to the midsection. Oh, a nice counter again, this time to an arm drag. Never thought I'd see an arm drag in a First Blood match. Very interesting. Oh, but he's back up. Oh, look at this. Into a DDT. Beautiful move. But again, does not bust Luigi open. So the referee cannot call it yet until he sees blood. He's got a kendo stick. Oh, right to the face. Right in between the eyes. Did that bust him open? I don't think so. How in the world do you prepare for a First Blood match? Oh, but look at this. Mario on the top rope. Oh, look at this. Inverted. Oh, went for the inverted 450 splash, but he missed it. Man, Luigi saw it coming in, a boot right to the face. Nice counter by Mario. Man, too bad this isn't a pinfall match. Oh, Mario setting up. Oh, man, the Mushroom Kingdom driver. That could bust a man open. Oh, look at this. Now going for it again. And this time the inverted 450 splash connects. That is the move he used to defeat Luigi for that championship. But looks like he's throwing some weapons out of the ring. I don't know if I agree with the strategy. Trying to set up for something. I don't know. Oh, here we go. I get it now. Removing the turnbuckle pad, exposing the turnbuckle. That is metal right there. That's one way you can bust someone open right there. Look at this. And a dropkick knocking Luigi out of the ring. And he's got that turnbuckle set up. If he throws Luigi face first into that, that might win him the match. But he's got Luigi up. A shot to the legs again. And oh, a big right hand and some more rights. These two just brawling. This isn't a wrestling match. This is a fight, ladies and gentlemen, for the Lightning Weight Championship. And because these two hate each other. It's always a shame to see brothers hate each other, but honestly, some of the things they've done to each other, not the most brotherly thing you'll ever see. I mean, Luigi did try to crush Mario's skull with steel steps, so I don't really blame Mario for being a little pissed off at him. And now look at this, trying to get back in the ring. All but a counter, and a shot right to the face. And Luigi back in the ring. Oh, look at this. Going for a powerbomb. Oh, he's got him up. And this time, it's a regular sit-out powerbomb. Just trying to punish Mario here. And now he's got him back up on his feet. And oh, super kick right in the face. And the referee again needs to check. See if he's bleeding. I don't think he's bleeding. But some more left hands right in the face. Oh, wait, what's Luigi saying for? Perhaps a screwdriver. Oh, can he connect with it? Oh, perhaps going for another powerbomb. Oh, no, but a counter into a DDT. Nice counter by Mario. Beautiful counter. But again, Mario in control. Neither one of these guys have started bleeding yet. Oh, I thought it was aiming for the turnbuckle right there. And, oh, dropkick sending Luigi flying to the outside. Man, neither one of these two can bust the other one open thus far. They need to get something like a chair. I don't encourage this. Maybe a blade of some kind. I don't know. Probably would be a bit of an ethical problem, but again, trying to crush each other's skulls is kind of an ethical conundrum right there in and of itself, but and a dropkick right in the face, and oh, right into the table, face first. But Mario has a table, and oh, well, went for a shot right in the face, but Luigi caught the table. Oh, a nice dropkick, nice counter by Mario. Pull the trigger again before Luigi can, but oh, this time the table right in the face, but again does not bust him open. And Luigi checking himself to see if he's bleeding, and apparently he's not. And the referee looking intently at both men to see if they're bleeding. And now Luigi back up on his feet, and Mario waiting for him. Oh, look at this. Oh, he's got that table set up in the corner. You don't have to have it set up like it's for a picnic. Uh-oh, this is bad news for Luigi. Oh, but a counter shot to the midsection, and throwing Mario into the table, but it does not break. But what does Luigi have on his mind here? Wait a second. What is Luigi doing here? Oh, wait. Oh, no. And oh, my God! a alley-oop again, face first through the table like we did with the trash can, but this time a lot faster, but Owen just dragging him on the table. But it does not seem that Mario is bleeding just yet. Man, what is it going to take? Only a springboard. Into a tornado DDT. How athletic is Luigi? But again, Mario is not bleeding yet. Owen now going all right into the exposed turnbuckle. That's what Mario set up earlier, and it's coming back to bite him. Oh, no, especially if Luigi uses it. Oh, dear God. Oh, Snake Eyes in the corner. Man, right into the metal. But it does not look like Mario is bleeding. It did not work. Oh, look at this. And the screwdriver connects. That's Luigi's finishing maneuver. But again, Mario is not bleeding just yet. What is it going to take to bust one of these two open? I get it, they're tough Italian plumbers, but this is ridiculous. And again, only this Luigi on the top rope. And, oh, went for a swanton, but missed it. He's just trying stuff at this point, honestly. It gets to a point where you're just trying stuff. Oh, but Mario accidentally clotheslined Alfred, knocking him clear out of the ring. And Luigi taking advantage of that with a running crossbody. Just accidentally clotheslined the referee. Went for Luigi, but Luigi moved out of the way. And a dropkick, and he just sent the referee flying. Oh, look at this. Oh, that time he connects with a Tope Con Hilo, almost into a Swanton on the outside. Very Daredevil-esque maneuver right there. Oh, and he's got a chair. He's going to try to open Mario up, but there's not... The referee's down. He won't be able to call it. Oh, but this time Mario has the chair. Oh, yeah, and look at this. Oh, right to the face of Luigi, but it did not bust him open. And another shot. Oh, but Luigi back up to his feet. Oh, he got him! There's blood all over the chair. He's busted Luigi wide open, but the referee is down. He can't call it. And Mario trying to go back over to the referee. Wait, what the? What's Mario doing out here? And he's got a lead pipe. Oh, my God. Right in the back with that lead pipe. Is this what Luigi meant? Really? Using these kind of tactics? He's joined up. And there's Waluigi. There's Waluigi and Wario coming out to assist Luigi. You've got to be kidding me. They both have chairs. Oh, right to the skull. With a concerto. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. Is Mario bleeding? How can he not be bleeding? Oh, I think the referee is stirring. Oh, no. They may have just cost Mario this match. This may have been... Oh, he's drenched in blood. And the referee sees it. And the referee calls it. You've got to be kidding me. You have got to be kidding me. Luigi got busted open first. But the referee didn't see it. Wario and Waluigi were Luigi's contingency plan, and they have paid off in spectacular fashion. Luigi has weaseled his way into a second Lightning Weight Championship reign. You have got to be kidding me. I mean, he didn't have Elmo and Cookie Monster come out. It was Wario and Waluigi who are in league with Luigi, and he is now a two-time Lightning Weight Champion. Just absolutely, I cannot believe that just happened. Alright, up next, ladies and gentlemen, is a matchup I personally have been looking forward to. It's Jason Voorhees versus Sephiroth, one-on-one in a grudge match. Now, on the previous episode of TAW Action, there was a triple threat match to determine who would go into the Excalibur Championship match, and it was Jason versus Sephiroth versus Jeff Hardy, and Jeff Hardy won by pinning Jason. And, of course, Jason blamed Sephiroth for the loss and attacked him backstage and threw him into a lighting thing, which... Honestly, I'm surprised it did not kill power to the building. I'm thankful that it didn't, because that would have been kind of awkward. So yeah, these two are going to fight, because why not? That's how we settle things here in TAW. The first time ever, it's Jason Voorhees versus Sephiroth, one-on-one. And both these guys were undefeated before that triple threat match, so I can kind of understand the frustration. So who is going to get their first singles loss here tonight is going to be Jason Voorhees or Sephiroth. Now, honestly, I'm kind of leaning towards Sephiroth here because Jason Voorhees has been pinned once in TAW. Sephiroth has never been pinned or submitted in TAW. He's lost that one triple threat match, but he was not pinned or submitted in that match. So I'm kind of going towards Sephiroth in this match, but again, can't really show that much bias for the lone commentator. But here comes Sephiroth. Of course, both of these guys are going to be looking to go for more championship opportunities. But of course, in order to do that, they have to defeat the other one here tonight. And what is sure to be... this is what I would qualify as a mean guy matchup. It's a match where it's not really that technical. It's just two dudes beating the crap out of each other. We've seen a lot of that tonight, but seriously, that's what this match is all about. Just two huge dudes just slugging each other. That's going to be this match. And still, ladies and gentlemen, later tonight, we of course have our Hardcore Championship match, which is Falls Count Anywhere, in our enormous main event, that 7-on-7 tag elimination match in our main event. But here comes Sephiroth down to the ring, who made his debut way back at Riot Central 2, squashing the Flash. And it was pretty much no contest, to be perfectly honest. He just absolutely just dismantled him. But here we go. This will probably be a little bit more tougher. The grammar in that was amazing. But here we go. This will probably be much more difficult for Sephiroth. Here we go. Jason versus Sephiroth. And Sephiroth starting with some shots and a nice kick in the midsection, but got caught with a big back body drop. And here we go. And now it looks like these two are laying in a bunch of body shots. And now side headlock by Jason. And going to show off some power with a nice snap suplex right there by Jason Voorhees. But a counter by Sephiroth and a clothesline right into the corner, and now a chop. Again, I say this all the time, but how in the world does a chop work? Nice running bulldog by Jason, but how does a chop work when someone's wearing a shirt over it? But whatever. And another back body drop by Jason Voorhees, being a little bit quicker than we're used to. And oh, what a big boot by... Oh my, that was a enormous big boot, sending him flying. Went for a clothesline, but Jason ducked underneath it. And a big right hand by Jason. And oh, what a combo, knocking Sephiroth off his feet. I still can't get over that humongous big boot. And oh, what a right hand right to the jaw of Sephiroth. And he's back to his feet. The one-winged angel trying to go to work here. Missed an uppercut. Oh, and another counter. Irish whip into the corner again. And this time the body splash connects for Sephiroth. The avalanche in the corner. And it looks like in the early going of this matchup, Sephiroth has taken command. And of course, as soon as I say that, I tend to jinx my wrestlers. I apologize for that. But Jason Irish whipping Sephiroth in the corner. A big clothesline. I expect to see a lot of clotheslines in this match. Just a hunch I have. And now I'll go behind, but a counter by Sephiroth into a big belly-to-belly suplex. And again, this is not a championship match. There's not anything on the line except for pride. And just want a little bit of revenge. Want to beat the crap out of the other guy. But, oh, taking Jason's leg out from underneath him with that nice little leg sweep and a knee right to the face. Nice move by Sephiroth. But a double leg takedown counter. And again, the momentum keeps switching back and forth. Oh, but a counter. And, oh, kicked right to the chest by Sephiroth. And now Jason going back to the arm. Now going for an Irish whip. Going to wind him up and then the Irish whip into the corner. Going to go for another clothesline. Oh, but a big right hand. Oh, but a counter by Sephiroth throwing him into the corner. And now look at this. And, oh man, another clothesline. There was some extra stank behind that one. A big left arm clothesline by Sephiroth out of the corner. And now another arm wringer. What's Sephiroth going to do here? And now it's like he's going after the arm of Jason Voorhees. And both knees right to the arm. Can you actually break Jason's arm? I mean, I assume you can, but like, can you? But oh, big power slam by Sephiroth. That's just one of those questions. And a big jumping elbow by Sephiroth. And again, it looks like, oh, wait a second. Sephiroth going to the top rope, and the Phoenix Splash connects. So athletic is the one-winged angel. But not going for the pin. Oh, look at this. Stealing one of Jason's moves, that running elbow into the cover. One, two, but a kick out at two by Jason. Man, that running middle finger elbow is one of Jason's moves, and Sephiroth stealing it. And now look at this, got him on the top rope. Oh, but a counter by Jason with a kick to the right of the face. And a diving axe handle. Not as athletic. Oh, and returning the favor with a double bird for Sephiroth. Did not take too kindly to having his move stolen. Yeah, right back in his face, I guess. But, and that's the two styles right there. Oh, look at this. Oh, Jason Voorhees got him, his hands wrapped around the throat. And a two-handed choke slam. A Kali Bomb by Jason. and now dragging him away from the rope so he can't get the rope break. And Jason, perhaps going for the cover. Going for the cover. One, two, and a kick out at two. Perhaps took a little bit too much time and did not hook a leg. Oh, what an uppercut by Sephiroth. Completely taking Jason off his feet. And now off of that, going for a Uranage, and that humongous Uranage by Sephiroth. And now into the cover, hooking the leg. One, two, not even a two count. That's got to be frustrating, but Ole missed a big boot. And a big right hand right to the face. And another one. Oh, but Jason cutting him off, and now setting up for a suplex. Oh, a stalling vertical suplex. Look at the strength of Jason, and some squats. Are you kidding me? More taunting as he showcases his power into a humongous vertical suplex. I think it's safe to say that Jason may have the strength advantage in this matchup. Very impressive. And now into the cover of that suplex. One, two, and a kick out at two for Sephiroth. Man, both these guys just laying it in. Oh, counter into a small package. Small package. One, two. Oh, only a one count. One, two, and a kick out at two by Jason. And look. Oh, immediately right into another one. One, two, and a kick out at two by Sephiroth. Man, Jason's tenacious in this matchup. Now side headlock. Turning it into another humongous vertical suplex. And it looks like Jason is focusing on the back and another double finger salute right there. Not family friendly whatsoever. Thanks a lot, Jason. We're going to get age restricted now because of you. But a nice double leg takedown counter by Sephiroth. And back to his feet. And now what is Sephiroth going to do here? Oh, what a headbutt by Sephiroth. A humongous headbutt just flattening him. And another small package. And cover one, two, and only a one. One, two. Oh, that was close. Two and three-fourths right there for Sephiroth. Almost had him there. Oh, look at this. Oh, and a jumping neckbreaker. Almost a zigzag by Sephiroth. Man, that whiplash on that move was absolutely devastating. But he's got Jason back on his feet now. And another Uranage attempt. And another Uranage on Jason. Will that be it? But Sephiroth not going for the cover. Not satisfied. Oh, going for a third one. And a third Uranage. That has got to be it. Into the cover, hooking the leg. One, two, and again Jason gets the shoulder up. How many times do you have to give a dude a Uranage before he stays down? Seriously. But oh god, Sephiroth was a little too slow on that. And Jason throwing him off the top rope. And look at these stomps right to the chest. I think it's safe to say Jason's getting a little sick and tired of this. Well, look at this. And Jason setting up for a gut wrench suplex. I had no idea Jason really likes suplexes. And now just a front mount. And just big right hands right to the face and nose of Sephiroth. And now Jason has Sephiroth back up on his feet. I'm going for another Kali bomb, or Jason bomb, I guess. Another double-handed chokeslam. You're going to knock me over and over? I'm going to give you a multiple chokeslams. How's that? Into the cover, hooking the leg. One, two, but a kick out at two by Sephiroth. Man, near fall after near fall in this matchup here. And another big boot by Sephiroth, just flooring Jason, trying to kick his mask off. Oh, look at this. Sephiroth appears to be frustrated here. Nothing he's doing is working. He hasn't been able to put him away yet. And a clothesline knocking Jason to the outside. And now Sephiroth, springboard. Oh, a springboard senton to the outside. High risk, high reward. Nice move by Sephiroth. Now we've got him on the outside. He's going to have to be careful here. Again, not a lot of padding. The referee's counting up to a count of two. And, oh, an elbow right to the back of the head. Oh, but blocked the punch. Now Jason got him by the back of the head. Oh, and a shot to the back of the head. Oh, now wandering over to the ring post. Oh, no. Oh, no. This is bad news for Sephiroth. And kicking his head into the ring post. My God. That was sickening. That could cause a concussion or something. That was absolutely brutal. Jason doing anything he can to win this matchup. And Sephiroth may be right for the picking here. I think just one crystal-like stunner will do him in. But he's got him back in the ring at the six count. And just launching him into the corner. And Jason, oh, look at this. He went for the Crystal Lake Stunner, but it got countered. And Sephiroth stealing the Crystal Lake Stunner from Jason. Oh, look at that. Right into the One-Winged Angel. And Sephiroth connects with both finishing maneuvers. Back to back into the cover. One, two, three. And Sephiroth puts away Jason Voorhees with his own finishing maneuver, immediately followed by the One-Winged Angel. What an impressive victory for Sephiroth, and another loss for Jason Voorhees. What a matchup. I told you this was going to be a mean guy match. Did I lie? No, I did not. These two absolutely demolished each other for our entertainment, and I was very entertained. That was a great matchup. And what a way to end it with both the Crystal Lake Stunner and the One-Winged Angel Facebuster. Sephiroth still unpinned and unsubmitted here in TAW and still undefeated in singles matches. And up next, ladies and gentlemen, this is our final one-on-one championship matchup of the night. The TAW Hardcore Championship is on the line in an Extreme Rules Falls Count Anywhere matchup. The current champion, Captain America, defending against former champion Sabu here tonight in this Falls Count Anywhere match. Now, in this match, of course, there are no disqualifications and no countouts. You can win by pinfall or submission anywhere in the arena. And here comes the current reigning and defending two-time TAW Hardcore Champion, Captain America. Now, this whole thing started way back at Riot Central 2. Well, actually, before Riot Central 2 when he was going up against Michael Myers, but at Riot Central 2, Captain America won the Hardcore title in an Elimination Chamber match. However, Raven came out, DDT'd the crap out of him to steal the title with the 24/7 rule stipulation. But Captain America quit. Well, then Sabu did the same thing later. But then Raven won. I'm getting a little bit of my history confused. Excuse me. Raven won the title back from Sabu on an episode of TAW Action in a Falls Count Anywhere match. DDT'd him on top of a broken table, and that led to Captain America challenging Raven, and Raven was defeated by Captain America after getting an Avalanche American adjustment on the steel steps and then the Stars and Stripes, Fisherman Buster. And now, then Sabu and Raven fought each other in a tables match to determine the number one contender on TAW Rivals, and that matchup was won by Sabu. And here we are tonight, Sabu versus Captain America in a Hardcore Championship match. Will Sabu become a two-time TAW Hardcore Champion here tonight? And remember, the 24/7 rules is still in play. Anyone can come out to this match and try to interfere and win the title. Of course, you have to pin Captain America. And, that's the 24/7 rules, ladies and gentlemen. Very unpredictable. You never know what's going to happen. But again, this is going to be a very interesting match. How will Captain America respond to the suicidal, homicidal, genocidal, not exactly in that order, Sabu in this matchup for the TAW Hardcore Championship? Again, no disqualifications or countouts. Pinfalls or submissions count anywhere in the arena. Anywhere on the planet Earth. Does not have to be in the ring. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. That's what this match is all about for the Hardcore Championship that Captain America won from Raven and is now a two-time TAW Hardcore Champion. And again, this is our final one-on-one singles championship match of the night. And here we go. I'm very excited for this, ladies and gentlemen. And we've seen several championships change hands tonight. Will this be the next championship to change hands? And here we go. Captain America versus Sabu. And here we go. Starting off with some right hands. Oh, but a block by Captain America. And a big jumping DDT. Speaking of Raven, beautiful DDT by Captain America right out of the gate. Now go behind. Oh, but a nice counter with a double leg takedown by Sabu. Never thought I'd ever say Sabu with a double leg takedown. Very interesting. Well, now Sabu with a springboard leg lariat. That's more of what I would expect from Sabu in this kind of match. And now nice running. That was an interesting kick right there by Sabu. I forget what that's called, but a big clothesline by Captain America. Just exchanging huge strikes right now in the early going of this match. Oh, we got caught with a hip toss. Beautiful hip toss by Captain America. Again, a two-time Hardcore Champion here. So he knows how to get it done in a Hardcore match. And now Captain America throwing Sabu into the corner. Oh, but a counter by Sabu and going after the leg. And went for a dropkick but missed it. And Captain America countered with an elbow drop right to the back. And I can't wait for the toys to come out in this match, to be perfectly honest. And Sabu with a big dropkick knocking Captain America right out of the ring as soon as I say something. Oh, now Sabu springboard. Oh, knocking him down with that senton. Nice move by Sabu. Very similar to the move Sephiroth used in the earlier match. And I think we might be seeing that exact move repeated. And here we go. And oh, man. Sabu landed right on his back. Captain America saw it coming. What a nasty landing. Oh, look at Sabu. Both of them have a weapon. Oh, man. Crutch right to the face. And now Sabu off that crutch shot into the cover. Not even a one count. Just hit the man in the face with a crutch and doesn't even get a one count. That'd be a little concerning. But, oh, head scissors right into the trash can. Captain America going face first into that trash can, just crushing it. And now just getting the crap beaten out of him went for a weapon, but again got hit with that crutch. But a big clothesline by Captain America firing back. And, a big left hand. That was almost a clothesline. I think it was more of a haymaker. But now got him back up. And another DDT, this time on the outside, spiking Sabu again. Not a lot of padding on the outside. No give whatsoever. And now Captain America going for another weapon. Oh, look at this. He's got another trash can. Oh, but Sabu from behind with a dropkick right to the back does not have that much of an effect on Captain America. I mean, he is a super soldier, so... And now throwing Captain America back into the ring. Don't really have to in this kind of match, but I guess it's safer, I guess. I don't know. Now he's got that trash can and... trash can right to the face of Captain America. Sabu definitely has, in my opinion, more of an advantage in this kind of matchup where he can use weapons. And now Captain America's in trouble. Sabu, what's Sabu going to go for here? Perhaps setting up for a moonsault. And Sabu with a beautiful moonsault taking down the champion. And now Sabu into the cover hooking the leg. One, two, but only a two count for Sabu. Not quite there yet. And a go behind by Captain America, counter. Oh, and a big jumping face buster by Captain America trying to get back in this matchup. And Captain America going for more weapons, it seems. I honestly thought that Sabu would be the one going for more weapons, not Captain America. That's a little surprising, in my opinion. Oh, he's got a kendo stick. And, oh, right, knocking him out of the park. Sabu tried to cut him off with that trash can, but Captain America swinging underneath the trash can right into the midsection and chest area of Sabu. Well, a taunting, very bad idea, Captain America. Left himself wide open for that Russian leg sweep, kendo stick assisted move right there. But Sabu not going for the pin. Now Sabu going for a weapon. And the ring is already starting to get littered with weapons, ladies and gentlemen. This is a hardcore championship match after all. He's got a table. Oh, table right to the face of Captain America on the outside. Throwing the table in the ring. What does Sabu have on? I mean, obviously he wants to put Captain America through the table, but Captain America, he's got the steel steps. And again, throwing it right into the table that Sabu set up. That was a smart move. But, oh, nice counter by Sabu with that swinging kick right there. He's got that table right back up. And, oh, right to the midsection of Captain America. Uh-oh. Captain America in serious trouble. His hardcore championship reign might come crashing down to an end. And Sabu with a huge leg drop right through the table. But it looks like he hurt himself on the impact with that move. Unable to capitalize. Both competitors are down. Man, this is wasting critical time here. Sabu needs to get a cover. Back up on his feet, into the cover, one, two, but only a two count. Those seconds wasted right there, lost, may benefit Captain America in this matchup. If Sabu was able to get an immediate cover on that, I believe he would have won the match. But that's not how it went, and now Captain America responding with an Olympic slam, and he may have landed right on that kendo stick. Now into the cover, one, two, but a two count for Sabu kicking out of it. And it's going to take so much to put either of these two away. And now off the way, what a Sabu got double underhook. And into a power bomb. Beautiful tiger bomb by Sabu. Now Sabu going to the top rope, perhaps another leg drop. But no, Captain America catching him in midair. And now setting up to finish him off with the American adjustment. And it connects right on top of that broken table. Into the cover, hooking the leg. One, two. No, but Sabu kicks out at two. That was close. Man, near fall after near fall in this match. Oh, kendo stick response right to the midsection. And Sabu just wearing out that kendo stick on Captain America. And, oh, what a DDT by Sabu. And now off that DDT, spiking Captain America, going for another leg drop. And connects with a second leg drop. And into an immediate cover. One, two. No, oh, Captain America kicks out at 2.5. I thought that was it. That was way too close. And now, oh, throwing him right into the steel steps. And it looks like Captain America may have tweaked his knee. And, look at this. Captain America on the top rope. Oh, but a counter shot to the chest. Now Captain America diving. Oh, ball got caught by Sabu. And into a powerbomb on top of the steel steps. That's it. We're going to have a new champion. Into the cover. One, two. But a kick out of two for Captain America. How resilient is this man? He just got caught midair and powerbombed on the steel steps. And right back into the ring. Oh, but got, man, just... His face just got caved in with that steel step shot right to the skull. And now look at the Sabu's got the trash can. And oh, just again hitting him with it, doing whatever he can to win this championship. But Captain America has taken a lot of abuse, but he's not done yet. And now just some stomps. I honestly think Sabu's a little frustrated here. Nothing is working. He just powerbombed the man on steel steps in midair. If that doesn't put someone away, I honestly don't know what will. Oh, trash can knocking Captain America to the outside and throwing the trash can on top of him for good measure. A little extra spite behind that. And now look at this. Sabu, what's he going for here? Oh, he's got a ladder, ladies and gentlemen. A ladder has been brought out. Things just went from bad to worse, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, look at this. Oh, a counter to a victory roll. One, two. Oh, but Captain America again kicking out. That was a close one. Sabu tried to surprise him there. Oh, look at this Raven. Raven on the rep. What's he doing here? Now Sabu going to meet him. Wow, he got across the ring fast. Got caught front chancery. And Raven with an even flow DDT on the ramp. Sabu is out and now going to the ring, going after Captain America, but oh, runs right into a clothesline. I think Raven might be trying to cash in on the 24/7 rules, but a counter to the punch right to the face. Shot in the midsection, and Raven setting up another even flow DDT. This might be it. Raven might steal the championship into the cover. One, two. Oh, but Captain America gets the shoulder up. We almost saw a repeat of Riot Central 2, ladies and gentlemen. But this time, Captain America kicks out of Raven's bread and butter, the even flow DDT. But Raven is incensed, trying to capitalize on the 24/7 rules once again. And for those of you who don't know, 24/7 rules means you can challenge for the title whenever you want to, as long as there's a referee present. Oh, went for a clothesline, but missed it. Shot in the midsection. This may backfire for Raven here. Raven set up with an American adjustment on the steps again. That's the second time this happened to this poor man. Now, Captain America back in the ring, but his back has turned Sabu from behind, and a big enziguri right to the top of the head, knocking Captain America right off his feet, and a big elbow drop, but Captain America again back to his feet. Man, what is it going to take to keep this guy down? He just absolutely refuses to lose this championship. And oh, spearing him right into the announce table, face first. And now Sabu's got that ladder back. I don't think Raven's going to be a factor in this matchup anymore, to be perfectly honest. I think he might just be unconscious from that American adjustment on the steel steps. Because, I mean, that's the second time Captain America's done that to him. Granted, this time it was not from the second rope, so I guess it's not as bad, but still. Uh-oh, he's got the announce table all messed up. Sabu might just be about to take this match home. We may be seeing a new hardcore champion right here, ladies and gentlemen, going to the top of the ladder. Oh, this is bad news. Oh, but Captain America gets off the table. Captain America saw it coming. Oh, this is a precarious situation, ladies and gentlemen, but a counter by Captain America. And, oh, dear God. Oh, my God. Oh, an American adjustment off the ladder, through the table, into the cover. One, two, three. An emphatic victory for Captain America, just launching Sabu through that table with a ladder American adjustment right through the announce table, and a pinfall on the outside of the ring. Captain America withstanding both of these ECW originals to retain the TAW Hardcore Championship in impressive fashion. He survived so much in this matchup, including an even flow DDT and a powerbomb on the steps, but Captain America is still the TAW Hardcore Champion somehow, some way. Next, ladies and gentlemen, is our main event, probably one of the biggest matches in TAW history. It is the 7-vs-7 elimination tag team match with so much on the line. It's the Team TAW versus the Clown World Order in this main event matchup. Now, if Team TAW wins, the Clown World Order will have to permanently disband. They'll never be able to tag with each other ever again. But if the Clown World Order wins, the Joker, the leader of the Clown World Order, will become a two-time TAW World Heavyweight Champion. So the TAW Championship is on the line in this matchup. And coming out first for Team TAW is Liu Kang, which sort of surprises me. I mean, given his track record, you'd think they'd save him for later in the match, but I guess they kind of trust him as part of a team leader alongside of the TAW World Heavyweight Champion Frieza, who's kind of the team captain. They're kind of like co-captains. But again, this is a huge match. And the way this is going to work, breaking the fourth wall, there is no 7-on-7 matches in 2K14. I don't even know how that would work. But the way this match is going to work, it's going to start off with a 3-versus-3 six-man tag. And every time someone is eliminated, the next member of their tag team will come out to this match. If you've seen the Magnation do a 7-on-7 tag team match, it's pretty much that same formula. And the second member of Team TAW coming out to the ring is one half of the TAW Tag Team Champions, Austin Aries, who was Tag Team Champions with Shadow the Hedgehog. And I'm very excited to see these two in this match because they were the ones who defeated Pennywise and Sweet Tooth to end their historic, long over 1,000-day Tag Team Championship reign. And will the third competitor be his tag team partner, Shadow the Hedgehog? But again, ladies and gentlemen, it is Frieza, the World Heavyweight Champion, Liu Kang, Sonic the Hedgehog, Zack Ryder, Tag Team Champions Austin Aries and Shadow the Hedgehog, and Dante that make up Team TAW. And here comes the third competitor, Sonic the Hedgehog. Not quite Shadow, but still a Hedgehog. Here comes the fastest thing alive, Sonic the Hedgehog, in this matchup. Former Lightning Weight Champion, the inaugural Lightning Weight Champion. And on the Clown World Order side, we have the Joker, who's the team captain, obviously. Sweet Tooth, Pennywise, Ronald McDonald, Killjoy, Phil, and a mysterious seventh competitor that is yet to be named. So, the Clown World Order has a secret weapon, ladies and gentlemen. And honestly, I don't like that one bit, but they're keeping it a secret. So, I guess we'll just have to find out as the match progresses. But I guarantee you, he'll probably come out last, whoever he is. So, that's probably how they're going to play things in this match. But the first three competitors for Team TAW are going to be Liu Kang, Austin Aries, and Sonic the Hedgehog. Who are the first three competitors going to be for the Clown World Order? Because, again, this is going to be a long match. It is a 7-on-7, and there are disqualifications and countouts. You can eliminate someone via pinfall, submission, countout, or disqualification. So, here comes the Clown World Order, the first three members of Clown World Order to be in this matchup. And Phil, formerly from the Blue Man Group, who defected to join the Clown World Order, and the Internet Champion Ronald McDonald, along with Killjoy, with a brand new haircut. Interesting. This is Killjoy's first ever pay-per-view main event, so I guess he's trying to dress to impress. So it is going to be starting with Liu Kang, Austin Aries, and Sonic the Hedgehog up against Ronald McDonald, Phil, and Killjoy. And again, I'm not surprised that the Joker's not leading the charge, so it's like Magneto says in X-Men The Last Stand. I know everyone hates that movie, but I don't. He says the pawns go first. That's pretty much how the Joker is approaching this matchup, by letting his pawns go first. So here we go, ladies and gentlemen. The biggest match in TAW history. And we're starting with Liu Kang and Phil in a collar and elbow tie-up to kick things off. And now breaking out of it. And now Phil taunting. Not very surprising. Of Liu Kang. Oh, fatality super kick right to the no way. Into the cover. 1, 2, 3. And 10 seconds into the match, Team TAW is up 1-6. I'm like, they've already eliminated someone. What? The Clown World Order is already down a man. We are now 6-7 in this matchup. Liu Kang just took Phil's head off. Wow. I was not expecting that. Right out of the gate, Liu Kang with a furious super kick, knocking Phil out of the match. But here comes the fourth competitor for the Clown World Order. Here comes Pennywise. Oh, and look at this. Oh, that pissed the clowns off. And oh, double-teaming Liu Kang. Look at this. Ronald with an old diving springboard clothesline right there. And now just some springboards and a back elbow this time by Ronald McDonald. Yeah, I think the Clown World Order is pretty pissed off at Liu Kang right now. But honestly, it's Phil's fault. He just started taunting way too cocky, and Liu Kang just took his head off. Wow. Immediate elimination. Now tag made to Killjoy. And snapmare. Liu Kang may live to regret this. And oh, springboard elbow drop. A lot of springboards to Liu Kang in this matchup here. Oh, look at this. Oh, went for a dropkick, but Liu Kang going right after Ronald, but turns right around. But a back body drop. Liu Kang trying to fight out of the corner. Man, the clowns have got to be going absolutely ballistic backstage. But what a move for Team TAW to gain the early advantage. It is 7-on-6, ladies and gentlemen. And now Killjoy is in enemy territory and a tag made to Austin Aries. And here comes one half of the Tag Team Champions. You could not have asked for a better way to start this matchup for the Team TAW right here. Man, what a way to kick off the match. And that is smart right there. Keeping Killjoy in his... Never mind. They were trying to keep him in the corner. But now he's in Clown World Order territory and a lot of counters right now. And now Armorer can't really see because of Pennywise's humongous body. And again, old Killjoy setting up for a vertical suplex. And oh, nice vertical suplex with a little extra torque on it. And now a tag made to Pennywise. And now into the ring. And oh, a knee right to the face. And again, the clowns have got to be furious. This is not how they wanted to start this matchup. If they lose, the Clown World Order is done. Oh, but look at this. Oh, he's got... Oh, look at the strength of Pennywise. Just manhandling Austin Aries. And just launching him through the sky with a fallaway slam. Pennywise is quite the terrifying foe, I must admit. And a big leg drop to Pennywise on Austin Aries. And a second one. And remember when they had the 4-on-4 elimination match, it was the Clown World Order who won that matchup over Team TAW. So, a lot of momentum switching around in this matchup. But as of right now, I would say that the Team TAW has the advantage. But a nice STO by Austin Aries and a dropkick right to the knee. I mean, Pennywise did just knee him right in the face, so it is smart going after it. And now Pennywise, Austin Aries perhaps going to tag in. Tag made to Sonic the Hedgehog. Here comes Sonic going up against Pennywise, and a big spinning heel kick right to the face. And now Pennywise going to try to tag in, but Sonic's not going to let that happen. And look at this smart move again, throwing him right back into his territory. But all counter by Pennywise. Now Pennywise is going to have to get out of enemy territory real quick, and throwing him and into a sidewalk slam by Pennywise. Remember, Pennywise is a former tag team champion, and Sonic the Hedgehog is a former Lightning Weight champion. And an Irish whip into the corner, almost into the referee. Alfred, you might want to move out of the way, and a big punch right to the face. And an open counter by Sonic, throwing Pennywise into the corner. And that beautiful running moonsault kick by Sonic the Hedgehog, and now just going to work with some kicks. And now arm ring by Sonic the Hedgehog, trying to slow the pace down a little bit. And now into Austin Aries, and a double team headbutt as Austin Aries was holding him in place. Man, I don't have a clue. Oh, nice hip toss by Sonic. I don't have a clue how this is going to go down. I did not see that beginning coming with that immediate elimination. But a nice Russian leg sweep by Sonic the Hedgehog. And it looks like Team TAW is firmly in control at the moment. And again, as soon as I say something, a counter. I apologize for jinxing my wrestlers every time I announce so-and-so is in control. Every time I say it, it turns around. By now throwing Sonic back into Clown World Order territory. And oh, what a boot right to the face. A player's boot. And now tagging in the TAW Internet Champion. Now the Internet Championship is not on the line in this matchup, but the Clown World Order itself is at stake in this match. Look at this Irish whip into a big Samoan drop by the Internet Champion, Ronald McDonald. Yeah, Ronald is... Oh, he's trying to hype his team up. Trying to get back into this after that huge elimination they suffered. Oh, but a counter into a back suplex. Nice counter by Ronald McDonald. This is why he is the current TAW Internet Champion. He's a three-time Internet Champion. And look, this got him up in a torture rack. And into a sidewalk slam by Ronald McDonald. Sonic the Hedgehog might be in a little bit of trouble here. And look at this, knocking his partners off the apron. Into the cover. Hooking the leg. One. Two, not even a two count. I think Alfred was a little bit too late on that cover right there. On top rope. Oh, and Zaguri by Sonic. Completely cutting him off. And look at the athleticism of that hedgehog. Just absolutely impressive with that huge Frankensteiner. Just jumping up there and getting him. That's just how impressive Sonic is. Kick to the spine. And now Sonic is back in control. Front chancery now transitioning into an armbar. Oh, but a counter. And Ronald responding with a shoulder block. Almost caught him in the Joker, but he's a clown. So, but now look at this. But got caught. Oh, turned it around into an arm drag. Nice counter by Sonic. Again, Team TAW in control. Oh, but look at this. Oh, and a nice leg sweep by Sonic the Hedgehog. And Ronald McDonald needs to make a tag out. What in the world is Sonic the Hedgehog doing? Oh, Sonic bringing out the heavy hardware, going after the announce table. Oh, and shot in the midsection, though. This is very risky for Sonic. I mean, he is in enemy territory right here. Oh, but look at this, throwing Ronald on the table. This is bad news for Ronald McDonald right here, but Pennywise from behind making the save. And if I was Ronald McDonald, I would get off that table as soon as possible. Oh, and here comes Austin Aries. Oh, but Ronald wisely getting off the table so it can't be used against him. But the table is live, ladies and gentlemen. And an Irish whip back into Team TAW corner. And a tag made to Liu Kang, the former TAW World Heavyweight Champion. And an Irish whip into the ropes. And a nice hip toss. And double kicks right to the back and sternum. And now look at this. Liu Kang setting up for a camel clutch. Going for a submission. But Pennywise and Killjoy right there breaking it up. And oh, Austin Aries went for a clothesline but accidentally hit the referee. That was accidental right there, but look at this. And, oh, what a kick! What a double team by Sonic and Liu Kang on Ronald McDonald. And Sonic still going after Ronald with a nice knee DT right there. And now Liu Kang going after the same leg with a nice leg breaker by Liu Kang. I'm going to take a lot of Ronald McDonald's movement. Very smart. And now an arm wringer by Liu Kang. Going to Irish whip him into the ropes. Irish whip. All but a counter. Oh, right into a beautiful belly-to-belly suplex. And Ronald McDonald wisely tagging out. He's had a lot of punishment done to him. And here comes Killjoy. And for shoulder block, but didn't work. Oh, caught him on a rebound with a clothesline. A vicious clothesline and a running bulldog by Killjoy. Now remember, in that 4-on-4 elimination matchup, Killjoy actually eliminated Liu Kang. All but a counter. And oh, facebuster counter by Killjoy sweeping out the legs. But they had a singles match on TAW Rivals, I believe. And Liu Kang was victorious in that matchup. And a wind-up uppercut by Liu Kang knocking down Killjoy. Oh, and look at this. Liu Kang's got him in a torture rack into a beautiful neckbreaker. Nice move by Liu Kang. And that might be it for Killjoy. Can we have another elimination here? Will it be 7-on-5? Into the cover, hooking the leg. 1, 2, but Pennywise right there making the save, breaking it up. And oh, a knee to the face. But Liu Kang will not be denied, going after him. And a lot of action going on in the ring right now. The referee needs to step in and insert a little bit of control over this matchup here. The Killjoy going right back after Liu Kang. And an elbow right to the face. And Liu Kang, Irish whip into the ropes. If I was Liu Kang, I would make a tag. But oh, a big shoulder block, taking him down, cutting off his momentum. Got him back up. Now Killjoy setting up perhaps for a power bomb. Oh, but a counter into a face buster by Liu Kang. Nice counter. Uh-oh, Liu Kang may be setting up for the fatality super kick again. All but a counter and an elbow to the face. But, oh, Sonic going after Pennywise here. And now knocking Liu Kang into the ropes. And now Killjoy going after Liu Kang's leg, trying to take away the fatality super kick from his repertoire. And going after Sonic with a running bulldog. And a tag made to Pennywise. Pennywise is now legal. If I was Liu Kang, I would go make a tag here because he's been in here for a little while. And... oh, knee right to the midsection off the double team. Smart move by Killjoy. A little dirty, but it was very effective. And now Pennywise setting up for a vicious powerbomb. That might be it. Into the cover. That may be it for Liu Kang. 1, 2. Oh, but Sonic breaking it up at 2.5. That was close. That's a good tag team partner right there. And now Sonic and Hedgehog has Killjoy in a front chancery. And now double team Liu Kang and Sonic. Oh, with a snapshot DDT. Nice move on Killjoy. I would go for the pin right there, but... Liu Kang going for an elbow drop. Not done with Pennywise just yet. Oh, but a counter into a small package. Small package here. This could do it. And oh, but Sonic's right there breaking it up immediately. Good tag team partner right there with Sonic the Hedgehog. Oh, look at this counter into a huge back body drop. And you saw how he struggled a little bit on that, but Pennywise went flying through the air. And look at this, and that weird leg snapmare thing by Liu Kang. And now, again, Liu Kang is in the Clown World Order's corner and gets thrown right back in the ring by Ronald McDonald. And these guys need to work on their strategy a little bit, but they're trying their best, doing everything they can to neutralize the other team. But again, the advantage is still with Team TAW. It is now 7-on-6. Oh, look at this. And a big clothesline as Killjoy was holding Liu Kang in place. And the Clown Order has got to do something here to get back in this matchup. Oh, what? Something like that. A massive clothesline by Pennywise, sending Liu Kang, turning him inside out. Just sending him flying into the sky. And now Pennywise off that clothesline, throwing him into friendly territory. And now tag made to Killjoy. Oh, and this is bad news for Liu Kang. Oh, setting up for a double team. And the backbreaker elbow drop connects. Man, attacking Liu Kang on all fronts. And now throwing Liu Kang into the corner. Oh, what is he going to do to Liu Kang here? Got him on the top rope. Oh, but a counter shot to the chest. Now Liu Kang diving with a nice cross body. Nice move by Liu Kang. Not going for the lateral press. Immediately tagging out to Austin Aries. Smart move. And Austin Aries is fresh. And now look at this. Now Austin Aries going after Killjoy. And oh, that nice spinning elbow. The discus five arm, I guess you could call it. Now he's got him up on his all but a counter. And into a reverse DDT. Nice counter by Killjoy. And now Killjoy. What's he going to go for here? Throwing him into the corner. And tagging in the internet champion Ronald McDonald. And here he comes. And oh, a big punch right to the face. And oh, but a counter. Champion versus champion right here. Tag team champion versus internet champion. And Austin Aries throwing him out. What's Austin doing here? Oh, a nice diving uppercut. Or an elbow right to the face. Nice move by Aries. And Austin Aries setting up for a pile driver. And oh, a huge sit-out pile driver That might be it for Ronald McDonald. Now Liu Kang, oh, taking out, I believe he took out Pennywise. And Austin Aries on the top rope, 450. Oh, but Ronald McDonald got the knees up off the 450 splash. And oh, right to the eyes. The referee did not see it. Oh, look at this, going for the crucifix off the rake of the eyes. Oh, come on, not this way. One, two, three. And Ronald McDonald, through cheap, dirty tactics, has eliminated Austin Aries with a rake to the eyes. But Sonic taking it to him right now. Who is going to be the number four for Team TAW here in this matchup, as Sonic the Hedgehog and Ronald McDonald are still legal? Here comes Austin Aries' tag team partner in the second half of the TAW Tag Team Champions, Shadow the Hedgehog. And I guarantee you, he is very unhappy that his tag team partner was just eliminated like that, with the rake to the eyes and the crucifix right there. All right, now, ladies and gentlemen, it is 6-on-6 right now. Team TAW, and I honestly believe Team TAW has lost the advantage. But a nice missile dropkick by Sonic the Hedgehog as Shadow makes his way to the ring here. In the corner, and what is Sonic going to do here? Shot to the midsection. Man, Team TAW had quite the advantage right there, but now it is more even now because it is 6-on-6. And now what is Sonic going to do here? Got him in the ropes. All bouncing and building up momentum into a huge arm drag. The most ridiculous arm drag in the game today, ladies and gentlemen. But Ronald McDonald's is in trouble. He's in the corner, but a counter, and oh, went for, he looked like he was going for a European uppercut, but oh, runs right into a big left arm clothesline. And now tagging in Pennywise, Sonic in trouble here. And oh, caught him into a nice hip toss by Sonic. Beautiful hip toss. And now Sonic, oh, perhaps setting up. Got countered, went for the supersonic drill, and runs right into a clothesline. What a counter by Pennywise. I believe Sonic was going for the supersonic drill, but it did not work. Oh no, Pennywise looking to finish Sonic the Hedgehog off, setting up for the It Factor, and it connects, just spiking Sonic right on the top of his head. That might be it. Into the cover. One, two, three. And Sonic the Hedgehog has been eliminated. We are now 6-on-5. Advantage Clown World Order. Man, that advantage has for Team TAW has quickly evaporated. They are now down two members. Who is going to be the fifth entrant for Team TAW? Oh, here comes the former Excalibur champion, Dante, who has had his own issues with the Clown World Order, which is why he joined Team TAW. He is number five for the Team TAW, ladies and gentlemen. What can he bring to the table in this matchup as Team TAW has lost their advantage? And now going after Liu Kang, Pennywise has him up and going for Snake Eyes. And you know Pennywise has got to be happy right now because he just eliminated a former Lightning Weight champion. Now throwing him into the corner and a tag made. And here comes Killjoy, double team move here. And just whiplash into the right into the turnbuckle, and now going right, and it looks like they're targeting the back and the upper neck, oh, the lower neck of Liu Kang here. Oh, and as soon as I say that, and that vicious neck breaker by Killjoy, and into the cover, hooking the leg. One, two, no, but a kick out at two by Liu Kang. It's going to take a lot more than that to keep Liu Kang down. He is a former TAW champion after all. And now an arm ringer and Liu Kang going for an Irish whip. Into the ropes. Oh, counter with a shot right to the stomach. And off that counter, Killjoy with a nice sidewalk slam, again going after the back of Liu Kang. Man, Liu Kang is in a lot of trouble. He's been in this match since the beginning and has been taking a lot of punishment. If I was Liu Kang, I would tag out as soon as possible. Oh, what a nice counter into a back body drop. Taking my advice, here comes Shadow the Hedgehog for the first time in this matchup. And Shadow immediately responding with a nice Frankensteiner, taking Killjoy down. Man, you know Shadow the Hedgehog is just itching to eliminate one of the clowns. And now he's in the corner just getting badgered around. And Killjoy trying his best to get out of the corner, but is not working out for him. And now look at this, Shadow with a nice Russian leg sweep, trying to keep the pressure on Killjoy here. Again, Team TAW have lost the advantage. They need to regain it somehow. And they need to start racking up some eliminations. Now going for an Irish whip. And into a nice power slam by Shadow the Hedgehog. Deceptively powerful is this black and red edgy hedgehog. And now a nice jawbreaker, and Shadow the Hedgehog is in command. Again, one half of the current TAW Tag Team Champions. And remember, Shadow and Austin Aries, regardless of how this match plays out, they will be defending the titles against Wario and Waluigi at a later date. But Killjoy just got launched to the enemy, right to the outside, in enemy territory. Take a shot every time I use the phrase enemy territory in this matchup, by the way. You'll be hammered by the end of the match, but anyway. And now Killjoy back in the ring under Shadow's control. And now look at, speaking of sickening neck breakers, Shadow responding with one of his own. And Shadow just having his way with Killjoy right here. He's got a mech up on his feet, shot in the midsection, and a nice DDT. Again, Shadow just beating the crap out of Killjoy right here, and I'm honestly enjoying a little bit of it. Because the Clown World Order has been a thorn in the side of TAW since 2014. We're almost in 2019. I want it to stop. And I'm kicking him into the corner. And, oh, a nice double team right there by Dante and Shadow the Hedgehog. That's a very edgy tag team right there, I must say. Dante and Shadow the Hedgehog. And Liu Kang there for just to even things out with Mortal Kombat. But a nice Enziguri, and now going after the legs of Shadow has just been taking it to Killjoy for the past several minutes. Oh, springboard. Oh, missed a springboard elbow. And, oh, knee to the face, cutting Shadow off. Honestly, Killjoy needs to tag out because he's taking a lot of punishment. But a punch to the face, and now trying to repay Shadow the Hedgehog for all those moves that's been done to him. Now an axe handle and a second one, knocking Shadow the Hedgehog down. And now knocking him into the corner. Well, the ropes, excuse me. Irish whip, and a big back body drop, sending Shadow flying across the ring. And again, if I was Killjoy, I would try to make a tag here. Because he's been in the match for a little while now. And oh, just ate a spinning back fist. The speed of Shadow the Hedgehog is absolutely ridiculous. Now, well, going at, again, I think Shadow might actually like just be the better wrestler between him and Killjoy. Because he is just punishing Killjoy right now. And now Shadow going to make a tag. Tagging in Dante. Here comes Dante for the first time in this match. And immediately into a hip toss. Killjoy is just getting demolished right now. And I'm enjoying every second of it. Oh, and a springboard. Oh, springboard splash by Dante right there. Again, Killjoy needs to get out of that corner. But a shot to the midsection. Oh, but a counter Irish whip into the ropes. And, oh, a nice shoulder block. Trying to change the momentum in this match. And again, Killjoy not going for a tag, which I question that kind of decision making. But, oh, a big right hand. And another right hand by Killjoy. I guess he's just trying to prove to the clowns that he can take a beating. Some more punches and another one as he has Dante perched. And, oh, big clothesline knocking Shadow off the apron. And a big boot sending Dante flying. And it looks like Killjoy is in control for the moment. And remember, ladies and gentlemen, there's still several other competitors to enter this matchup. Oh, boy. Dante is in serious trouble. And just got his jaw popped right in the face by Pennywise right there off that double team. Now throwing Dante right back into the ring. Man, that was a huge right hand. And now shot to the leg. And now Killjoy. Oh, with a Shining Wizard, and I believe Dante's been busted wide open. Now into the cover hook in the leg. One, two, but a kick out at two by Dante. Gonna take a lot more than that. Now some punches. And another right hand. Oh, but Dante countering. Dante going for the Devil Trigger. And Shadow, oh, look at this. Oh, the Devil Trigger connects as Shadow deals with Ronald McDonald. Into the cover on Killjoy. One, two, three, Team TAW with another elimination. This time, Dante eliminates Killjoy with the Devil Trigger. And I believe we are now 5-on-5 here. And here comes the fifth competitor for Team Clown World Order. And I believe it is Sweet Tooth. This is the tank of Team Clown World Order, ladies and gentlemen. This is the CWO's Leviathan. He is their Godzilla, their Incredible Hulk, whatever you want to call him. I think things have just gotten a little bit worse for Team TAW here, although I do believe it is now 5-on-5. Oh, the springboard, and the Arbiter connects to the Internet Champion. Dante's still on a roll here, and there's Sweet Tooth getting into the ring. And off this tag made, and here comes Shadow the Hedgehog off the tag. Look at this. Oh, headlock, and oh, double stomp right to the back of the Internet Champion. Oh, and all that sets up perfectly. Shadow setting up for Chaos Control, and Chaos Control on the Internet Champion, and into the cover, hooking the leg off of that Chaos Control. One, two, three, and Ronald McDonald has been eliminated. Man, oh, look at this. Oh, Shadow going right after Pennywise. Man, what a move. And now here comes the sixth competitor for the Clown World Order, and I believe it is the head of the Clown World Order, the leader of the CWO. I believe it is the Joker himself. He is a former World Heavyweight Champion and a former Excalibur Champion, and has been using his clowns to terrorize TAW for several years. But I believe it is now 4-on-5, and the advantage, I believe, has gone back to Team TAW in this matchup. It is 4-on-5, ladies and gentlemen. But man, Team TAW needs to continue to press the advantage. They need to get more eliminations and just avoid getting eliminated. But a nice DDT by Shadow. And they need to avoid getting eliminated, and they need to start getting more eliminations if they want to stay in this matchup. Oh, look at this. Oh, Shadow off that DDT's got him. Oh, look at this. Top rope into a neck breaker. That's an absolutely vicious move right there. But Shadow doesn't seem to be done. Throwing Pennywise into the corner. And a tag made to Dante. Here comes Dante. Now throwing him right into the knees of Dante. And that nice throwback right there by Dante. What a double team sequence right there. And now Dante knocking Pennywise into the ropes. Now Dante with an Irish whip into the ropes. And now just showcasing his athleticism. And Dante with big elbow. And I believe it's got to be very cathartic for Dante to be able to eliminate Killjoy like that earlier in this match. But that nice breakdancing leg drop. And here comes Liu Kang. Liu Kang now in this matchup. Taking a little bit of a breather. Liu Kang has been in this match since the beginning, ladies and gentlemen. And now Liu Kang with a diving crossbody, this time with the lateral press. One, two, but a kick out at two by Pennywise. That was a near fall right there, ladies and gentlemen. Came really close to eliminating Pennywise. And now he's got him in the corner. And Liu Kang again showing off the athleticism with a nice enziguri with a little bit of theatrical emphasis, I guess you could say, on top of it. Now he's got Pennywise in where he wants him, right where he wants him. And an Irish whip in, I don't know if I agree with, that was not a good move by Liu Kang right there. I think it was just the adrenaline was just flowing, but he just got decked by Sweet Tooth. And now, knee to the midsection, and Liu Kang's in trouble. And now look at this, from behind, Pennywise trying to keep Liu Kang in the Clown Warlord's corner. And now tag made to Sweet Tooth. Remember, Pennywise and Sweet Tooth have been tag team champions for over 1,000 days before they lost the titles. And another backbreaker elbow drop combo, this time by Sweet Tooth and Pennywise, the former tag team champions. They've been a great tag team for several years. And now look at this, that humongous spinning Uranagi and a leg drop. This is worst case scenario for Liu Kang right now. He cannot afford to be in there very long with Sweet Tooth, but a counter. And look, we got caught with another Uranagi. Man, Sweet Tooth is all over Liu Kang right now. Remember, they had a big rivalry back in the day, dating way back to the first Perfect Storm event. Now tagging in the Joker, here we go. The Joker and Liu Kang, these two absolutely hate each other. This is honestly probably the main rivalry behind this whole entire thing. But another double team, a boot right to the stomach. And now the Joker just punishing Liu Kang right here. But Shadow right over there trying to do what he can. Now throwing Liu Kang into the corner. So Joker got on his mind here. Team USA sign in the crowd. Odd, random, but whatever. And a tornado DDT by the Joker just punishing Liu Kang. And now Joker setting up for a frog splash into the cover, hooking the leg off the frog splash. One, two, but a kick out at two by Liu Kang. It's going to take a lot more than that. Oh, look at this. Setting up for back suplex into a neck breaker. That's a vintage Joker move right there. Now Joker perhaps going for another frog splash. Oh, but this time Liu Kang got the knees up and Joker just bounced off him. And speaking of knees, running knee strike right to the face. And now Liu Kang wisely tagging out. Here comes Dante. And now Dante absolutely hates the Joker. Because of the Joker, Dante lost the Excalibur Championship. Look at this. Going for an Irish whip. Oh, throwing him to the outside of the ring. Dante just wants to punish the Joker. Big right hand. Oh, boy. Look at this setting up. This is classic Dante with the back suplex to the apron. And, oh, man, the Joker's starting to get punished here. The leader of the CWO is getting dominated right now. Now the referee counting. Remember, there are countouts and disqualifications in this matchup. And now throwing the Joker into the corner. And now open a counter by the Joker with some elbows right to the face, trying to get out of this. And now look at this Joker trying to turn the momentum around. Throwing Dante right into the corner, just that hard whiplash into the turnbuckle. And now going for it again. And this time throwing him chest first into it. Yeah, look at this, turning him around. Joker going for an O'Connor roll. Can he get him here? One, two. Oh, but Dante reversing it into one of his own. One, two. Oh, but another counter to a schoolboy. Schoolboy, one, two, three. He got him. The Joker with an elimination. Dante has been eliminated by the Joker. We are now 4-on-4, ladies and gentlemen. Team TAW again losing the advantage. And here comes the sixth man for Team TAW. Here comes Zack Ryder, hopefully coming out here to even the odds. We are all even, ladies and gentlemen. It is 4-on-4. Here comes Zack Ryder. And now it's with Shadow the Hedgehog and the Joker. Honestly, this is a matchup I would like to see. The Joker versus Shadow the Hedgehog. Oh, but look at this. Shadow with a counter. Look at this setting up. And Chaos Blast! He's got him into the cover. One, two. Oh, but a kick out by the Joker right there. That was close. He almost had him right there. Man, Chaos Blast almost eliminated the Joker right there, but a big clothesline. And now off that clothesline, what's Shadow going to do here? Shadow going to the top rope. Up 450. Oh, but the Joker moves right out of the way. That was close. That could have been an elimination right there, but the Joker saw it coming. And now that may have been a big mistake for Shadow the Hedgehog. And again, oh, wait. Oh, look at this. Joker. Oh, man, the flatliner into the bottom turn. Well, the second turnbuckle. Nice move right there. And Sweet Tooth right there. Just reminding Shadow at all times he's right there. And here comes Sweet Tooth. And look at this, going right after Shadow the Hedgehog. Got him in a front chance. What's he going to do? Oh, but a counter knee to the midsection. Going to the top rope. And then, oh, nice spinning kick by Shadow. Nice move, trying to get back into this match. And he has Sweet Tooth dazed. Not very often you see that, but an Irish whip counter. And look at the Sweet Tooth. Oh, the Laughing Death uppercut connects. That might be it for him. Oh, but look at this, Zack Ryder keeping Sweet Tooth from going for the pin. That's how you do it, Zack Ryder. That is my boy right there. Keeping Sweet Tooth away from the pinfall, but oh, Sweet Tooth firing back with an elbow to the face and a leg drop. Man, Zack Ryder may have just saved Shadow right there, and he's still trying to reach in there. Very gutsy move, but he may have just delayed the inevitable, ladies and gentlemen. Shot in the midsection. Oh, Sweet Tooth setting up for the twisted DDT. That might be it for Shadow the Hedgehog. And the Joker, oh, look at this, taking out the members of Team TAW into the cover. One, two, three, and we have another elimination. Shadow the Hedgehog is out. And we are now 3-on-4 advantage Clown World Order. And here comes the team captain of Team TAW. There may be hope left. Here comes the World Heavyweight Champion, Lord Frieza himself. The World Heavyweight Champion. His championship is on the line. This is a TAW championship match, ladies and gentlemen. And at the last second, will Frieza be able to show us why he's been TAW champion since 2015? But oh, runs right to a knee. Liu Kang just got kneed right in the face. And now look at this Irish whip throwing him right into the ropes. And another back body drop on Liu Kang. Liu Kang has been the Iron Man in this matchup so far. He's been in since the beginning. But he still keeps just absorbing punishment in this match. He needs to make a tag or something. Oh, look at the Zack Ryder again trying to do what he can to distract the Clown World Order and keep them away from getting any kind of offense. And Liu Kang taking advantage with a nice chop. Zack Ryder, I'm very impressed with Zack Ryder right now, just in the right place. And a tag made. Here comes the TAW champion. Well, look at this. Oh, a double super kick. Who would have ever thought we'd see Frieza and Liu Kang do a double super kick? Oh, and the death ball. That's it for Pennywise. Into the cover, hooking the leg. One, two, three. We are even, ladies and gentlemen. It is now going to be 3-on-3, but who is the seventh man for the Clown World Order? We're going to find out in just a second. Wait. Oh, my God. What? What? Is that Bane? They got Bane. How in the world did the Clown World Order get Bane to join them in the... He's the seventh man. Bane is the seventh man for the Clown World Order. Are you seeing this right now? I am in shock, ladies and gentlemen. He was already a match earlier tonight against Broly in that cage match. The Clown World Order has somehow managed to ensnare Bane. How? But now Frieza going right after Luke. They are shocked. Team TAW shocked. I'm surprised. But Frieza going after the Joker. Oh, look at this. Frieza with a springboard shooting star press to the outside, showing us why he's champion. Oh, and a fatality super kick to Sweet Tooth. Joker. Oh, look at this. Oh, a German suplex to the Joker. Frieza is just all over the place right now. But man, look. Oh, look at that. That's how I approve of that. Just knocking Bane right off the apron with a big right hand. Man, you should see the look on the faces of Team TAW right now. They are in shock right now. Bane is the seventh man for Team Clown World Order. You are not hearing me incorrectly. Oh, man, I can't even believe that. But a nice suplex by the Joker. But ladies and gentlemen, these are the final three competitors. This might as well just be a six-man tag team elimination match right now. And oh, and a big dropkick by the Joker. And it looks like Joker has control over the TAW champion Frieza. Now look at this. I thought Joker perhaps was going to go for a tag right there. He still might be thinking about it. Throwing him into the corner and a tag. Oh, I thought he was going to go for a tag, but he's got Frieza in the Tree of Woe. What's he going to do here? Oh, got countered with a knee to the face. Nice counter by Frieza. And a big drop kick. And now Frieza again in control. Oh, look at this. Tag made to Liu Kang. Again, who would have thought we'd see Liu Kang and Frieza on the same page? This is just insanity. Oh, look at this. Off the elbow counter. And now Liu Kang on the top rope in his corner. And a moonsault on the Joker. Nice move by Liu Kang. Into the cover, hooking the leg off the moonsault. One, but only a one count. Not enough damage has been done to the Joker just yet. Now look at this Joker trying. Oh, here comes Bane. The Joker is tagged in Bane. Here we go. And going right after Liu Kang with some huge strikes, just knocking him down with that big right hand. I still cannot believe that they somehow convinced Bane to be on their team. Like, just how? What happened? What did they promise him? Like, this has to be some kind of deal or something. Now go behind and Bane in control and a Russian leg sweep on Liu Kang. Team TAW, honestly, I think they're in a little bit of a disadvantage. They've been in the match longer. They have less fresh men than the Clown World Order does. Also, they don't have the shock value of having Bane. Oh, nice monkey flip by Liu Kang trying to stay in this match. Oh, and a shot right to the back. Liu Kang trying to build some momentum and a big clothesline on Bane. And I still can't believe Bane's in this match, but a counter with a shot to the back of the head. And now Bane with a big back suplex on Liu Kang. Right, again, Liu Kang needs to get out of the ring. He has been in this match since the beginning. He got the first elimination with that really quick elimination of Phil. Oh, but a counter. Oh, but he hangs on. Oh, and a Mongolian chop. Oh, but a counter by the Joker and a big right hand just staggering Liu Kang. But I don't think he's going to take to that lightly. Again, knocking Bane off the apron and going after throwing the Joker in. Liu Kang has had enough of the Joker. He's just done. But Bane right back in the ring. Oh, a big running knee strike on Bane by Liu Kang. Now, again, if I was Liu Kang, I'd go for a tag. Oh, but look at this. Oh, I blocked the punch and a big right hand. Liu Kang still firing back with some more right hands. Now go behind. And, a headbutt right to the back of the head, knocking down Liu Kang. And Bane, again, in control of Liu Kang at the moment. Again, this does not look very good for Liu Kang. Remember, wait a second. Bane showcasing his power. Military press into a power slam. That's what we're talking about with the strength of Bane. But remember, if the Clown World Order wins this match, Joker is TAW champion. But if they lose, the Clown World Order is done. They have to break up. So much riding on this matchup. Oh, but a counter by Liu Kang. Shot to the midsection. Shot to the leg. And a beautiful cartwheel in Suguri. And now immediately tagging in Frieza. That was a smart move. Now here comes Frieza, the World Heavyweight Champion, going after Bane here. Now look at this, throwing him into the ropes. And a big chop by Frieza. And a big forearm, and it looks like Bane is in a little bit of trouble here. Oh, look at this, turning him around. And Frieza with a German suplex, and into a bridge. Look at that thing, into the cover, one. But the Joker right there immediately breaking it up. Oh, look at this, Bane going right after Frieza. And these two, Joker getting out of the ring. Here we go, just exchanging right hands. And, big elbow accidentally nailing the referee. Oh, but Frieza, a big super kick again, borrowing Liu Kang's move. And wait, the referee's down. Wait, Zack Ryder just threw a chair into the ring. I don't know how smart this is, but, look at this. Frieza using the steel chair that Zack Ryder threw into the ring. The referee did not see it. Can Frieza eliminate Bane here off the... I don't know if I condone that, but... And in the cover, hooking the leg. Wait. The referee did see it! Frieza's been eliminated! That's a disqualification! Are you kidding me? Frieza has been eliminated, and honestly, it's sort of Zack Ryder's fault. That backfired! Oh, Frieza's furious! Going right after Zack Ryder! Just tackling him on the ramp! That was a bad move by Zack Ryder right there. That absolutely backfired. And now Team TAW, and Frieza, what are you doing? You'll lose the title if you keep this. Oh, a bit just going after Zack Ryder. We're now 2-on-3, and Frieza has just lost it. Oh, and look at this. Oh, and a death ball on the ramp. Zack Ryder is out, and Liu Kang is worse for wear, trying to take advantage of that chair shot. That was a historically bad plan right there by Zack Ryder. And this might as well be a 3-on-1 handicap match right now because Zack Ryder's out. Oh no, this is worst case scenario right here, ladies and gentlemen. Oh no. Oh no, that table's right there. Oh, he's got him up and powerbombing Liu Kang. The back of his head went right to the table. That could break someone's neck. It may be only a matter of time before the Joker is crowned a 2-time TAW champion right here. I can't believe Frieza was just disqualified like that. But Liu Kang back in the ring. I just pin the man. Just get it over with. Irish whip into the ropes. Oh, counter, counter, counter. Tilt-a-whirl into a small package. Small package. He's got him here. Small package. One, two, three. Liu Kang just eliminated Bane with a small package. There's still life in Liu Kang, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, block punch. Only shoving off. And a fatality super kick to Sweet Tooth. Where is Liu Kang getting this adrenaline from? Just knocks Sweet Tooth's head off into the cover, looking like one, two, three. It is now 2-on-1, ladies and gentlemen. Springboard. Oh, but Joker missed it. Missed the knee. And oh, a knee right to the back. Can Team TAW do this? And a big clothesline. This is their biggest opportunity, but Zack Ryder back on his feet. Oh, this is what I've been waiting for. The end of the Clown World Order. What? Oh, what? What? What was that? And in the cover. Are you kidding me? Zack Ryder just betrayed TAW. Are you serious? He just hit the Liu Kang with a Rough Rider, and now the Joker, with the Joker driver, Zack Ryder just left the building. And no, into the cover. One, two, three. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. Did that really just happen? Zack Ryder just hit Liu Kang with the Rough Rider and left the building. The Joker is a two-time TAW World Heavyweight Champion. What just happened? Zack Ryder just turned his back on TAW. Just, I cannot believe this. I am shocked. The Joker is a two-time World Heavyweight Champion. Wow.